So yeah, I definitely think that it comes from his dad for sure.
Look at that.
What is it?
I don't know.
I have no idea. I'm gonna keep it on though.
I'm put it down in the pocket.
I'm not surprised.
No, I'm gonna put it in the backpack.
They're afraid to get bro.
Beth is used to the drill now. Wherever they are, Lou will want to take some cleanup time. That's just part of the deal with him.
She knows and she understands that I got to get it out of my system, kind of thing. You know, if I see a beach and I know there's stuff on it and I pass and I drive by it and I don't, I know I won't be out there, you know, for a while, then, you know, I got to do it. Like.
Nice.
Clear. Keeper.
Put a piece of blue in there. That's rare.
Blue's they're hard to find.
Well, Lou is a person that likes to be on the go. Like my dad once said to me, he said, I don't think there's a lazy bone in that man's body. And, you know, he's right because there is not.
Well, we certainly haven't seen it.
Only one of a kind he is. Like, and he's a rare breed, and he loves the environment, and he loves outside. And if he's home in the weekend by himself, I bet you he's out combing the beach or walking trails or picking up somebody else's garbage.
I think a lot of people don't realize that water is life, and without clean water, your ecosystem is pretty much at a standstill. What kind of an environment are we going to leave for our kids and our grandkids and future generations coming after us? I like to believe that we're making a difference. And I know in my heart that you know, the stuff out there, it doesn't belong. And I do believe that we are inspiring others to do their part. I mean, we get people to send us pictures from, you know, from up at their cabins to do their own little cleanups, and you know, where they've been, you know, following us, and they've been conducting their own little cleanups and bringing some of the material while cleaning up their own little areas.
And so, Lou and Jason head out for the next location on their list.
What do you see when you see those two guys going off in the truck together?
I see two happy guys, just happy to be hanging out, spending some time and doing something good.
On land and sea, more changes underway on the family farm.
We hire Canadians who want to learn about farming. They come and stay on the farm and do a paid internship with us. Grab a whole bunch by the bottom and just hopefully they get some hands-on experience that is useful to them.
How new ways of attracting workers are helping farmers reap the harvest. That's next time on Land and Sea.
The following is a live presentation of CBC Sports.
If you want to be the best, you gotta pass the test. You gotta give it till there's nothing left. Leave nothing behind. Give it your all, your body, your heart, and your mind. Stand up, stand tall. No fear, don't stop until you reach the top. You gotta give it your all, and that means everything you got. You gotta take a chance, gotta take a shot. You gotta give it your all, and that means everything you got. You gotta take a chance, gotta take a shot. Don't stop until you reach the top. You gotta give it your all.
a beauty. Today we are crowning the 2020 CEBL champion, and it's an all-Western Canada affair. Fraser Valley Bandits taking on the Edmonton Stingers right here on CBC Sports as we welcome you inside our CBC Sports studios. Annie Petrillo, Javon Shepherd, it's Championship Sunday. Javon, let your Canadiana flow because you came prepared for today's matchup.
I don't mind if I do.
Check that out. Look at that. Yeah, that's right. Today we are crowning the ultimate Canadian champion in the CEBL. And it's the teams that finished 1-2 in the round robin as well in Edmonton and Fraser Valley. They also happen to be the final two teams standing. What do you make of this matchup?
You know what? Not to mention, Andy, these are the top two offensive teams in the league as well. Fraser Valley is a team that's been training for this opportunity since early May via Zoom and FaceTime calls. That's unheard of.
Yeah.
Then you have a team, Edmonton. This team has, you know, they want to avenge their semifinals loss last year. So there's a lot going on and a championship on the line.
Love it. All right, and who will be the final one to lift the trophy? We have more on today's match. Let's take you inside Meridian Center in St. Catharines, Ontario with Amy Otterbert.
Thanks, Andy. I spoke to head coach Jermaine Small for the Stingers, and he told me over this entire process, his team has gotten so much better defensively. And on the other end, offensively, the contribution is so much more balanced. So they're pretty confident coming into this game. On the other end, Kyle Julius, in typical Coach Julius fashion, he told me he's wiped everything off the table, point blank. We cannot win a championship game today if we let the other team score 100 points. So I think you can expect some typical Bandits havoc on the defensive end. The other thing you can't take away from this Fraser Valley team is the heart and, most important thing, they believe they can win this ball game. Guys.
Thank you, Amy. Well, we are going to highlight two players we think are going to be a factor in today's game. And when it comes to the Edmonton Stingers, no surprise, we're going to be talking about Goodwater, Alabama native Xavier Moon, last year's league MVP. This year, doesn't look like he missed a beat. What makes him so effective?
You know what? Xavier Moon is a stud. This guy was MVP caliber last year, and he's cruising into another MVP season. He's a guy that's averaging 18 points and 5 assists. And I think the most important thing about him is how unselfish he is. He's getting guys the basketball on his team in the right places. On top of that, He has four other guys on the court with him that are shooting 40% from the three or above. So he's able to distribute the ball and apply more pressure to defenses because it forces them to play him honest.
All right, so who's going to be tasked with defending him? You believe that's going to be Toronto, Ontario native Junior Cadogan.
Junior Cadogan. Now, let me tell you, there's something special about this guy. He is a willing defender, and, you know, his numbers aren't going to impress you offensively, but he's held his opposing point guards to less than 10 points over the last four games, and this is when his team has peaked. Now, on the offensive end, he has a four to one assist ratio, and that just means he's taking care of the basketball and getting it where it needs to be for his team.
Well, when these two teams met during the round robin, it was the Bandits who walked away with a 113-100 victory. Let's get to the two gentlemen calling today's championship game. It's Peter Ruckgazer and Joe Rasso.
Thank you very much, Andy and Javon. Well, Joe, this Edmonton team, they've got a big three, and it's a massive big three. Moon, Daniels, and of course, Jordan Baker. And Jordan Baker, he has done everything for this Edmonton team in this summer series.
Yeah, Jordan Baker is a whole package player. He's been incredible. He does whatever you want him to do, and he never cheats you out of effort. He scores the ball. He passes the ball very well. He's an exceptional rebounder. He defends the ball incredibly well. He's the heart and soul of this team. He is relentless. And what he does for this team, he leaves his DNA on everybody that comes near him. Opponents, teammates at practice, I'm sure. He's just relentless and keeps on coming. A very good player and really exemplifies what this team's all about.
Now for Fraser Valley, head coach Kyle Julius has told Malcolm Duvivier over and over again, be aggressive. He's definitely been aggressive the last couple of games, Joe.
Well, he absolutely has been, and he scored 18 points last night, but he's a rare physical shooter. He can get to the rim. As a three-point shooter, he gets to the foul line. He plays through contact. He is aggressive, and he's averaging 7 rebounds a game, which is really important.
So two Canadians to really pay attention to in this championship game. Andy and Javon, back to you.
Well, the Bandits, their motto this season has been chip on our shoulder, heart on our sleeve. Edmonton, they have the most returning players from last year. They remember what it felt like to get eliminated by a bucket in the semis last year. And it's the moment we've all been waiting for now. 2 weeks of intense games, and we're down to our final two teams. Who will be the last standing? Tip-off is next.
Tim's camps can be life-changing for youth who need it most. This summer, we're coming together virtually.
At Tim's camp, everyone always supports each other, no matter what walk of life they come from.
At Tim's camp, no one judges me, and everyone here is invested in helping me find the best version of myself.
Tim's camp has definitely led me to prepare for my career, and it's also shown me that my limits are really non-existent.
Every coffee you buy on August 12th will change a kid's life, like it did for me.
Canada Deposit Insurance Corporation is a federal agency that protects your money when you deposit it with any of our member institutions. Look for our logo, however you bank. CDIC, see how we protect your money.
Hey, do you happen to have
A tampon? What size?
There's more than one size.
It's about your flow, okay? It changes, so should your Tampax. Only Tampax has 5 sizes and a leak guard braid. If it hurts to remove, go down. Leaks, go up.
Super regular. That's my combo.
Tampax, the only tampon with a leak guard braid to help give you more leak-free periods.
Time to Tampax? What's your combo?
Here's Candace, who works from home and then works from home. But she can handle pickup even when her bladder makes a little drop-off. Because Candace has poise. Poise under pressure and poise in her pants. It takes poise.
When your car console gives you, DQ gives you the 2 for $5 super snack menu. Mix and match any 2 snacks, like a cheeseburger with a small sundae. All day, all for $5. Look for drive-thru and takeout options at your DQ. DQ, happy tastes good.
New Microban 24. Watch as Microban 24 kills 99.9% of bacteria. And then, even after multiple touches, keeps killing bacteria for 24 hours. I trust Microban 24 to keep killing bacteria for 24 hours.
Here's to the experiences we create. The moments we share. Wherever we are. San Pellegrino. Enhance your moments.
Can't get to the salon? You can still look and feel your best with Finishing Touch Flawless, the easy way to instantly and painlessly remove facial hair. No redness or irritation. Salon-style results at home. Available at fine retailers everywhere.
Made first with wholesome whole grain oats. Nature Valley Lunchbox, the perfect tasting peanut-free snack.
Whole grain oats, cinnamon, and Cheerios all rolled into one for a deliciously satisfying crunch. Available in cinnamon and oats and honey.
Right now, you're tapping, swiping, and sending money more than ever. We can help with unlimited transactions and free Interac e-transfer transactions. And as always, we're here with everyday advice. The TD Unlimited Checking Account. You could get $300.
Did someone say free pizza? Free pizza? Oh, I guess I just did. Right now at Pizza Hut, buy one pizza and get the second free. Free. Use code 879. 879. I'd listen to that echo. Now that's delivering.
You searched a good price. You found a great place. Trivago. Compare accommodation offers from the leading brands for every budget and get the best deal for you. Hotel, vacation rental, more options. Trivago.
We know what it's like for your whole world to change overnight.
To have your life affected by circumstances beyond your control.
To experience setbacks that you never saw coming.
We know what it's like to face an uncertain future.
To not be able to put a date on things getting easier.
But we know that one day they will.
We know what it's like because we are Paralympians. See you in 2021.
Okay, I've been working like 3 jobs. Probably why I never see ya. Probably why I never have time for the fake friends I won't be ya. Oh God, I've been running now. Up early when the sun is out. Not selling out my own soul, but those real ones, they coming out. Oh look who's reaching out. Old friends wanna feature now. They don't work, so they need it free. Ooh, gonna tell everybody talking stage. Better be in that convo.
It's the championship game. We take you inside the Meridian Center in St. Catharines, Ontario for the starting lineups of Fraser Valley and Edmonton. Here we go.
Now let's meet the starters for the second-seeded Fraser Valley Bandits. A 6'1" Canadian guard from Marquette. Please welcome number 30, Junior Cadogan. A 6'2" Canadian guard from Akron, number 11, Malcolm DeVivier. A 6'6" Canadian forward from Oregon, number 15, Olu Ashalu. A 6'4" guard from Washington State, number 8, Marcus Capers. And a 6'6" Canadian guard from Creighton, number 4, Jahens Managa. The head coach and general manager of the Fraser Valley Bandits is Mr. Kyle Julius. And now let's meet the starters for the top-ranked Edmonton Stingers. A 6'5" Canadian guard from the University of Calgary, number 23, Mumbi Diawara. A 6'5" Canadian guard from Central Arkansas, number 10, Matthew Kemba. A 6'8" forward from Mississippi State, number 30, Travis Daniels. A 6'2" guard from Morehead State and reigning CEBL MVP, number 2, Xavier. And a Canadian 6'8" forward from the University of Alberta, number 8, Jordan Baker. The head coach and general manager of the Edmonton Stingers is Mr. Jermaine Small.
So there you have it, the player introductions for this championship game. These two teams met early in this summer series, and it was Fraser Valley with a 113-100 victory. But both teams have kind of changed since then, haven't they, John?
Yeah, they've changed in personnel slightly, but they've grown. And these are the two teams that have grown, and in particular Edmonton, they've gone undefeated since that game.
And this Fraser Valley team, after Cam Forte left the team, they changed their identity a bit. They got back to getting in the mud and being more of a gritty team.
Yeah, they're still fast, they play tough, and they play very good defense, but they share the ball a whole lot better right now.
So, the big names in this game, Xavier Moon for Edmonton, you have Junior Cadogan, Jahens Managa. Who do you see really thriving in this atmosphere, in this championship atmosphere?
Well, I think the main players, because they've handled the big stage. But if I look at Fraser Valley and say, look out for somebody, Kyle Johnson. He's been playing hurt, and he comes off the bench. And then if you look over at Edmonton, Matthew Kemba has been outstanding. And he has been a force, and this has been a coming out party for him. And that's where, but I think the thing is, nobody will jump out in front of their teammates here. Both teams play good team basketball, and if somebody's not doing well today, they'll go to their teammate.
And here's the guy right here, Malcolm Duvivier, has really come on. We talked about it in the opening. He's really come on, shot the ball well, been aggressive, and they'll need more of him here this afternoon as well. And Jordan Baker, Mr. Everything. He's rebounded the ball, been a facilitator, been a scorer. And Jermaine Small had talked about the fact he doesn't need to score to be effective, but he has done that here in this summer series.
Yeah, he's done a real good job of scoring the ball here. But they've got so many players that average double digits, and you bring Adika Peter McNeely off the bench, and now they've got six guys that they can, you know, play as starters.
And there you take a look at the defending MVP of this league, Xavier Moon, and we're underway. Championship Sunday, CEBL action. And here's the man that got it going yesterday in the semifinals, Diawara. He set the tone in that contest. Xavier Moon. Daniels puts it on the deck, spin in the paint, and loses the handle on it. Maniga picked it up, and now Junior Cadogan, steady veteran for this Fraser Valley team, ball in his hands.
Not surprised, but Johannes Maniga with the steal there because he's leading them in steals.
Cadogan hits the iron there, brought down by Diawara. Diawara looking for three and training it, picking up where he left off at the beginning of yesterday's semifinal game.
He started the semifinal the same way. He is an offensive scorer. He will give you instant offense, and when he does score, his entire game gets better.
The Vivier now. Up high for Maniga. There's Marcus Capers. They kick it out again, go inside out. Too strong, ball up for grabs. Capers has it. Maniga, a little side adjustment, looking for a triple, can't get it. But that's exactly what this Fraser Valley team has to do, Joe. They have to rebound the ball if we're going to have any success here.
They're great at second chance opportunities. But Johannes Maniga gets the ball here on the kickout. Nice pump fake, and then draws him one more time to go to the free throw line for three.
Maniga to the line. Yesterday, he had 13 points, four rebounds, six dimes. He was 2 of 3. From the free throw line in that victory.
And having the first foul of the game on Xavier Moon would only help the Bandits.
Knocks that down. And early going here, Edmonton in front, 3-2.
Right off the bat, you see Fraser Valley's trying to deny Xavier Moon from getting the basketball. So on that, they're going to play real tight on him and try to deny him the basketball.
Here's Cadogan. That's going to be Cadogan's assignment all afternoon long. They find Daniels from downtown. Can't make it. And now Maniga with the ball. Oluwaseolu trying to get to the bucket on Daniels. Too strong there. Had 4 points yesterday. Two of those points were the Elam winner against Hamilton.
And Olu's comfortable in there. He's got the whole package as a post player, and he's going to try to score right at the rim.
Oh, look at that move there by Xavier Moon. We've been seeing that all along here in this summer series.
For a small man, he gets to the rim. He finishes it incredibly well.
Maniga goes cross court, Junior Cadogan, and Junior Cadogan rattling down a tray.
Junior's confidence came yesterday in Elam time. He time knocked down a big three. So yeah, early in this game, he's taken all the open shots they're giving them.
That's what big games are all about. Three times to the Sweet 16, one time to the Elite Eight with Marquette during his NCAA career. Diawara, shot clock went running down. Daniels had it in his hands. They're going to say that it went off of Capers.
So Xavier Moon gets in straight lines. He becomes very difficult. And if you don't, and he reads real well, he'll finish if he has to. And if you come, he'll pass it off.
Only 1 second left on the shot clock. Catch and release by Kamba. Maniga has the rebound, and he gets it to Duvivier. Duvivier trying to take it to the rack, and he's blocked. And there's some defense from Jordan Baker.
Good defensive transition, but great defensive transition that you get on. But when you shoot corner threes off it, you get runouts. And good defense by Edmonton.
Tied at five here in the early going. Diawara. Maniga trying to contain him. Goes baseline, feeds it, and the big time slam by the big fella, Travis Daniels.
Edmonton has lots of size on the floor. So if you cause rotation where one person has to rotate, and if that one person is Olu Ashlu, then you've got people diving to the basket.
Another size advantage in this game that goes against Fraser Valley. Ashlu shoots it from outside, well off the target.
Yeah, not what they wanted on that, but that was, he was forced up against the clock and had no choice.
Diawara tried to feed Baker, and that pass was no good.
So when you get past the first person and you cause somebody to rotate to help, open man dives to the basket.
So Edmonton off to a good start here. The big man getting the job done. Back with more CEBL action right after this.
This is more than just mac and cheese. This is Annie's, made from organic pasta and real white cheddar cheese. Annie's, more than just food.
2 dates, 10 peanuts, chocolate chips, and sea salt. Just 4 simple ingredients. That's all. Larabar.
Struggling to clean tough messes with wipes? Try Mr. Clean Magic Eraser Sheets. Just wet, squeeze, and erase icky messes in microwaves and on stovetops. For an amazing clean, get the power of Mr. Clean Magic Eraser in disposable sheets.
With Insalatissime Rio Mare, eating well Italian style is easy. Only high-quality tuna, selected legumes and vegetables, many delicious recipes to eat everywhere. Insalatissime Rio Mare, real Italian taste.
I'm feeling good. So good. I just thought you should know.
Welcome back inside the Meridian Center. I'm Amy Odbert with maybe the MVP, our four corners DJ for the game. And I know you're going to work and talk at the same time. Pretty incredible. This is your second year back with the CEBL. Music and basketball, their cultures are so intertwined. Why do you think that is?
I mean, I think that growing up with especially hip hop and basketball, it just goes hand in hand. It just always has. And you play basketball, you listen to music on the courts, and we bring it to the pro level here. It's awesome.
Thank you for your incredible work during the game. I know you can spin a track. Can you step back and hit a J?
Always, all day, all day, all day.
Guys.
Thank you very much, Amy. DJ Four Corners here at the Meridian Center, providing everybody with a little bit of entertainment, some music. And right now, Edmonton in front, 7-5, 6:03 remaining in this opening quarter. Here's Merrick Cassidy. He's been a steady player for this Fraser Valley team. And Ashlu gets called for an offensive foul.
He had real good position in there. Didn't think he needed to be that demonstrative with the action. But this Edmonton team has so much size that they can switch on four different positions. And they do that when you go into that dribble weave like Fraser Valley just did there.
First team foul for Fraser Valley. Diawara coming over. Looked like he was going to set a screen. Now he's going to drill a three. Missed it. They get the offensive board. Another opportunity here. A nice fake by Moon. A little short J. And he sinks it.
And that came from the offensive rebound. That screen, we call that a ghost screen. It looks like he's going to set it and then flares off to the wing looking for a three-point shot.
Edmonton by five. Excuse me, by four. Inside for Ashlu, kicks it out, they swing it up high. Klassen can't make it.
Good offensive series there by the Bandits. They got it inside to Capers, not just for him to score, but for him to start the offense from there. As soon as a little bit of a double came, he kicked it out and created a good shooting opportunity for them.
But this is a team, this Fraser Valley team, as Amy was saying when she was talking to Coach Julius, they cannot give up 100 points here and get in a run-and-gun situation with this Edmonton team.
Yeah, they want to muck it. They want to muck it on defense and try to pick up the speed on offense, but slow it down defensively.
Here's Glasson being chased by Moon. Ashalu. Kyle Johnson now trying to get inside position and can. Although Ashalu steps back, misses that one. Tavarian Nix gets the offensive board. And then Merrick Glasson.
That's the second time in this game so far that an offensive rebound has led to a three-point shot and 6 points.
Here's Moon again. Shoots over top of Johnson and drains it. And now you've got Xavier Moon feeling a little bit here in the early going of this one.
Yeah, great pull-up jumper and good defense there by Kyle Johnson. That's just the lift of Xavier Moon.
Johnson hits the side of the backboard. And now here comes Edmonton on the run. Kemba off target.
Edmonton will shoot a three-on-three in transition. They'll settle for the three. They feel that they can get that because they rebound so well.
Vivier just misses that. And it's going to be Fraser Valley ball. And, you know, Jermaine Small has said that when we're rebounding and running, we're a very good team. And that's been on display throughout the summer series.
And both these teams are very good when they're running on offense. They're exceptional at it. The one thing that Edmonton can do is they've got some big size that can come down and score off the misses.
Nix is fouled. And Tavarian Nix will go to the line.
So, teams have done a real good job of their baseline out of bounds. He just get a little slip in there and look for the quick dunk.
Okay, Joe, what are the keys for today's game?
Well, if you're Fraser Valley, you have to defend from the inside out. You can't let them get to the rim like they did with Xavier Moon there. Straight line attacks. And then you have to score off of your defense. And both teams are looking to run out, but they do an incredible job. They lead the series with 22 points a game. If you're Edmonton, dictate the pace of the game on offense. Xavier Moon, he drives the bus. And then defend the three-point line early, but then also late, because for late clocks, they're always looking to kick it out for a three.
Saw Nix at the line yesterday in that win against Hamilton. Fraser Valley shot just 65% from the charity stripe, 13 of 20. That needs to improve here this afternoon in this championship game. I think of Peter McNeely, he had lost it. Billy Clark was there and couldn't hang on to that ball. And Brody Clark had a foot injury, missed a couple of games. He seems to be okay. He had a strong game coming off the bench yesterday. There's Maniga. It was backcourt mate Klassen. Klassen misses that one. Himself trying to go down the lane. And they wave the bucket off. And that's a
good defense
foul
here. And you watch Johannes try to set himself up, and it's more the shoulder dip by Kareem Self that causes the charge. Because I felt Johannes was moving. If he doesn't dip his shoulder, it's not a charge. It's a defensive foul.
Klassen directing traffic here. Klassen, little pocket pass inside, and Nix able to get the deposit for two.
Great pass, but the screening from the Bandits has been exceptional. They're solid, strong screens.
Deacon Peter McNeely misses there on that jumper. Fraser Valley by one. And now we've got Merrick Klassen. He got nicked up a little bit there.
So Merrick Klassen is very good at, he's a pass-first point guard. And Kyle Johnson, I don't know if he was looking for the dump-off there or if it went through his hands. I think he was looking for the dump-off.
So now Fraser Valley into the bonus, so Klassen will shoot a pair.
One thing that Fraser Valley does incredibly well is they defend hard, they get their hands in the passing lanes, they're very physical, but they don't foul. They're sitting here with one foul, and they're playing aggressive.
2:40 remaining in the first quarter. Peter McNeely defended well there by Klassen. Cody Clark down the lane, got bumped, no call. And now Fraser Valley move it up the court. Here's Klassen. Klassen. And he's knocked down, and they're going to call a travel on Merrick Klassen. Klassen has got a bewildered look on his face. He doesn't agree.
Yeah, he's pretty surprised by it. He does a real good job of getting himself to the middle. He feels he did a nice job there. He may have an argument.
And Merrick Klassen yesterday, big part of that victory against Hamilton with 12 points, 4 rebounds. And Klassen and Junior Kernugan are going to be so important for this backcourt for Fraser Valley.
Yeah, what Merrick Klassen does is he just constantly puts pressure on you because he tries to get the ball to the middle. He'll score, and he gets there, he looks to score, but he's a great passer from there. Not only the dump-off passes, but he's a great passer. He'll find the open three-point shooters.
And Merrick Klassen playing in the Ukrainian League, started his pro career off in the British League. And when you look at him stature-wise, you go, wow, okay, there's not much of this guy, but he is a real stout defender.
Yeah, he is physical. Don't be fooled. The Point Loma grad has just been a very good pro his entire career, and he's fast and he's quick. He's very quick, and he's been playing very good basketball for them. The fact that they have two point guards on the court helps their team tremendously.
Okay, Amy has more on Merrick Klassen.
Yeah, he came into the CEBL highly motivated. Pete, you already mentioned his career in Ukraine. Well, it got abruptly stopped, like most people with COVID, but, you know, he was shooting over 50% from the three. His team was on the brink of a championship. His GM calls and says he was 48 hours to get out of the country. He was craving to get back on the court. Guys.
Thank you very much, Amy, playing for Kiev and the Ukrainian Super League. And a lot of these guys that you're seeing here today, they had their seasons disrupted because of COVID-19, so they are liking this, having a chance to play in this summer series.
Like Fraser Valley, after the timeout there, went to a 2-3 zone and is not giving Edmonton any chance of second chance opportunities.
Jens Menega missed that deep three. He had problems from three yesterday in that victory against Hamilton. He was just 3 of 12 from beyond the arc.
But he made a big one in Elam time.
That's right. Right now, 14-11 lead for Fraser Valley. Here's Daniels, turnaround Jay. Klassen comes in there, gets that board.
And this is great defense by the Bandits because they're forcing Edmonton, in that case Daniels, to settle.
Strong move by DeVivier, but he can't finish. Peter McNeely, no good, loose ball. Brody Clark cleans things up and gets two.
And that's the second chance opportunities that they're looking for. They do a real good job of getting five guys involved in that transition.
Maniga, look at the footwork and the defending here from Xavier Moon. Vivier, under a minute now in this first quarter. 4 on the shot clock. Got to do something in a hurry here. DeVivier, short jumper. Missed that one. And now Edmonton push it up the court. Green Sell, little Euro step. Blast it in, and he's fouled.
Yeah, great rebound and great run out. They're not always looking for their point guard. They're looking for the first guard who's open, and this time it's Kareem Self. Does a nice Euro step, draws the contact, and finishes with his left hand.
So Menega gets called for the foul.
Kareem Self at the line, trying to complete.
One of the role players on this Edmonton team. And you get a sense from the role players that if something were to happen, an injury, guys like Self, Peter McNeely, they could take on a more expanded role.
Yeah, that bench, just that next man up attitude is there. There's some solid players out here. You can only play five at a time.
Klassen, that ball going deep to Nix. To Dugan, gets a cross court. Vivier can't make that shot from range.
And a good shot, a good creation by Junior Kadugan to get to the middle and find his open shooter.
This will be the last action of the first quarter. Deke Peter McNeely, and that's defended by Nix as he came in there and swatted it away. Now Edmonton thinks it's a goaltend. Nonetheless, we've done a quarter here in this one. Edmonton, Fraser Valley, a CEBL title on the line. Back with second quarter action right after this.
Here's another cleaning tip from Mr. Clean. Cleaning tough bathroom and kitchen messes with sprays and wipes can be a struggle. There's an easier way. Try Mr. Clean Magic Eraser. Just wet, squeeze, and erase tough messes like bathtub soap scum and caked on grease from oven doors. Now Mr. Clean Magic Eraser comes in disposable sheets. They're perfect for icky messes on stovetops, in microwaves, and all over the house. For an amazing clean, try Mr. Clean Magic Eraser and Mr. Clean Magic Eraser sheets.
Oh. Looking for something, Jessica?
Yeah, dinner.
Ah, a friend over.
Uh-huh.
May I suggest some black diamond cheese?
Oh, I love diamonds. Black diamond.
Now, let's add some pepperoni, tomato sauce, and bagels. What do we have?
Cheddar pizza bagels.
Dinner.
Born chefs.
We should keep them.
Black diamond cheese, bringing together meals that are beyond delicious. Black diamond, since 1933.
Welcome back. Edmonton leading this one by one. Let's hear from Kyle Julius in his huddle with Fraser Valley.
Bottom guard. Rivetsino. Big
shoot the first kick out. You had a layup at the rim. You had a good, we got to be strong. We got to be strong. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Together, one, two, three.
And that was the huddle from a little earlier on in the first quarter. Break down what Kyle Julius had to say there in that huddle.
He just wants him to be aggressive. More than anything else, he wants to be aggressive, wants to be cool. At this time, you don't want to talk about negative stuff. You're just constantly pushing forward because there is no tomorrow. You got to win today. So I think you'll find both coaches in their timeouts talk about advancement, how we're going to get better, what do we got to do a little bit better, and keep the guys' confidence.
And you know, yesterday in that game against Hamilton, I believe it was in the third quarter, late third quarter, where he really motivated his team and he challenged his team to be a little bit better.
And they did.
Here we go, second quarter action. 15-14 for Edmonton. Edmonton showing some defense there. And that was Xavier Moon. He was trying to get it deep there for Travis Daniels.
Real nice set there by the Bandits and real good defense by Xavier Daniels.
Need time on the shot clock here on the inbounds. In the corner. Green cell. Left that one short. Here's Marcus Capers, kicked out of yesterday's game. A couple of tees, and he drives, and he puts it away.
And Olu Ashlu did him a favor there. Olu did a real nice job of clearing that lane with a screen as he was setting himself in the post.
And it was a shame that Capers got kicked out of that game. He had 11 points in just 16 minutes of work. And there's Capers, yeah, active hands there. Johnson's gonna try a three off the mark.
Yeah, Marcus Capers can guard a lot of positions. He's got length, he's got size, and he's got incredible athletic ability to get up off the floor.
Xavier Moon, little hook shot. Boy, another trick in his bag of tricks that we've seen here in this tournament. Inside is Capers. He gets surrounded by Edmonton Stingers, and he's getting up slow. Moon, yes, little finger roll.
And that's that straight line attack. If you allow him to get down there five on four, you've got to space out. You give him a straight line, he's going to take it.
So now Edmonton by three. Junior Cadogan. Johnson, that hits back iron. Fraser Valley coming up short, a couple of trips on offense.
Both teams are doing a good job of limiting each team to one shot. They're cleaning up the boards on both ends. So Xavier Moon is fast and quick, and he gets to the middle. He's always looking to score first, and if you take that away, he's going to pass off. But nice, nice little running hook there, uses his length.
He can score so many different ways. Right now, this Edmonton team up by three. Screen set there by Asolu, and there's Merrick. Classic coming off that screen and knocking it down for three.
And Olu Asolu did a nice job of setting that screen. It just tells you that the Bandits are just much more physical on both defense and offense.
And Moon comes right back and hits a two.
And analytics in the NBA will tell you that's a bad shot, but for Xavier Moon, like DeMar DeRozan, that's a good shot.
Kyle Johnson, last couple of times for him, coming up empty, shooting that outside jumper. Here's Moon. Moon lobs it in there. He's looking for Jordan Baker, and it looks like they're going to call. No, that ball just went out of bounds. I thought they were going to call Baker on a foul.
Yeah, Jordan Baker's got a great seal inside. And either he gets his foot tangled up or Merrick Claussen does a nice job of pulling the chair on him. But he had the inside position. He felt he got fouled and stopped him from getting the ball.
Here you see his numbers here in seven games in the summer series, averaging 13 points and close to 10 boards a game. Olu Asolu, he goes for a tumble, kicks it out, not a lot of time in the shot clock. Junior Cadogan loses the handle, gets it back again. Cadogan puts up a wing and a prayer.
Shot clock violation, Edmonton basketball.
So a shot clock violation.
So great defense here. Everybody's getting their hands on it late in the clock. Shot goes up. And then the foul is called after the shot clock violation. And it's called unsportsmanlike.
So Jordan Baker will go to the line now. Olu Asolu will sit down for a bit.
That entire series started with for Edmonton, when the ball went into the post, you'll find, watch that Edmonton, in the case Jordan Baker, he'll go down and not only double team, but sometimes he'll bluff the double team, and that's enough to, for someone to pick up the ball.
Now Edmonton will have possession here. Right now, the way this game is being played is right down Fraser Valley's alley, right?
Absolutely. They're making it a, their half-court defense has been exceptional.
And Jordan Baker can't haul that ball in. Fraser Valley will take over.
And that's just a physical play of Malcolm Duvivier there. He just never stopped, and Jordan Baker got caught in a loose ball. The officials are letting him be physical.
Klassen has been very good so far in this game for Fraser Valley. Here's Capers. Tries the jumper, and Capers, he's on his game.
Good job identifying the 2-3 zone, and they went right to the middle with it, with Capers finding a nice little hole to get his jumper off.
We talked about Capers getting kicked out of yesterday's game. He's lucky he wasn't suspended for this final. Here's Clark. Clark moving in. Came off the rim. Duvivier wants to run now. Maniga. Capers, little up fake. Here's Junior Cadogan. And Cadogan, he's hit a couple of threes. Had a little chat there with his buddy. And this, small.
And this is what they do. They come out and five guys in transition. They don't score on the primary, but they score in the secondary. Good ball movement, good recognition. All it takes is one guy to get penetration middle for another guy to get open.
Brody Clark now. Jumper no good. Maniga, he had the rebound.
Yeah, I just love the physical play of the Bandits.
So now a timeout called. The Edmonton want to talk things over. Okay, we'll step out. It is Fraser Valley 24-22. Fighting for the ball here in St. Catharines.
Tim's camps can be life-changing for youth who need it most. This summer, we're coming together virtually. At Tim's Camp, everyone always supports each other, no matter what walk of life they come from. On August 12th, buy a coffee, change a life.
Did you know that every single flush flings odors onto your soft surfaces? Then they get released back into the air, so you smell them later. Ew, right? Mm. That's why Febreze created Small Spaces. Press firmly and watch it get to work. Unlike the leading cone, Small Spaces continuously eliminates odors in the air and on surfaces, so they don't come back for 45 days. Now that's one flush and fresh bathroom. This is more than just mac and cheese. This is Annie's, made from organic pasta and real white cheddar cheese. Annie's, more than just food. 2 dates, 10 peanuts, chocolate chips, and sea salt. Just 4 simple ingredients. That's all. Larabar.
Xavier Moon in the summer series, averaging 17.3 points a game. He's already got 12 already, though.
Yeah, and he's doing a great job because Edmonton's not scoring in the half court, and he's finding a way to score in the half court. He's being able to get to the lanes in the half court, and when you give him the full court, then he's ridiculous. But it's in the half court right now that he's keeping Edmonton alive.
And this fellow was a last-minute cut with the Toronto Raptors G League affiliate 905. He almost made that team.
He's going to be making some team next year, no matter where he plays. This guy's got some future in basketball. He's going to make himself some money.
Last few years playing with the London Lightning in the NBLC. And Clark can't hang on, and there's Jens Maniga going right to the deck to save that ball.
Yeah, Jahanz Maniga on the floor, Jordan Baker on the floor. It's something we've seen all series long.
There's Jordan Baker, and he's going to get a lot of consideration for top Canadian in the summer series.
We've got a lot of Canadians on this. On both these teams, have had great series. Jahanz Maniga has been outstanding.
22 seconds. Maniga in this summer series shooting 41% from 345 from the field. He has shot the lights out. There's Cadogan, little crossover, taking it right to the 10, and Junior Cadogan getting all pumped up.
He identified a match that he'd like. He had Brody Clark on him on the perimeter and identified it immediately that he was going to take it straight on.
He ran up the court here. He scared me with that look in his eyes. And there's the finish by Brody Clark for Edmonton.
One of the first times Edmonton's been able to score easy against Fraser Valley in the half court.
This game has gone back and forth here. 4:30 remaining in the second quarter. Cadogan around the elbow, missed that one.
So when Junior has the match and he wanted, in that case on Brody Clark, he just goes north and south, and now he can use his size and his girth to get himself to the basket.
Oh, that's a scary look, Joe.
It's his game face.
Wow, wouldn't want to meet him in a dark alley. Kamba up high for Daniels to swing it over for Diawara. Diawara looking for three. Baker in there, bats it out for Kamba, and Kamba's knocked down. And Edmonton's going to go to the line.
Baker with a huge offensive rebound. And you don't have to grab the ball. He just kept it alive. But I thought that offensive set there, Mambi looked like he was heading, he was hunting a shot. And you got to let the flow of the game come to you.
And Matthew Kamba, boy, I talked about Maniga shooting the ball very well in this CEBL Summer Series. Matthew Kamba has just been money. Comes to shooting the ball as he makes the first of two. And those numbers are very impressive.
And the job the Bandits have done on him in the first half have been impressive, because these are his first points of the game.
So we're tied at 26. DeVivier, Cadogan. Klassen looking for options. Klassen now wants to put it on the deck and drives. Oh, defended as that was swatted away by Daniels.
at 6'8 and athletic and strong. Daniels let Barrett Klassen go up before he decided to go up and block it.
There's Daniels now in the post. Move on the inside.
Take care of it at one end. You get rewarded by the basketball gods at the other.
Vivier, he turns it over. On the run again is Edmonton. Here's Baker. He's trying to feed Kareem self, and they're going to say that it's going to be Edmonton. Ball went off of Klassen. Here's some defense from Daniels.
So Daniels knows he's got size and length. Great block, and then he gets up, comes back down, gets a great seal, and just works his way inside.
And that's a pretty tough assignment for Capers to handle Daniels in the block.
It's a tough assignment for anyone. This guy's got an NBA body on him. He is ripped.
Get Jordan a seat.
Let's listen now to Jermaine Small as he addresses his team.
Whose ball is it? What block do you want it on?
This block. Just
which block do you want it on?
No, please, go right into it.
What's where?
Ball's on that side.
It's on this side. So let's go Tatum, and they're going to go zone. Let's go Tatum. Listen, if you, Deeks, you can go on this spot here. If you catch it, look to score. Because they're looking at this action, they know it. Just look to score, but get here and get the shot. Guys, if they're backpedaling, go to the rim and finish. All right? You're the help guy. Don't
Joe, over, tell us what Jermaine's talking about there.
Well, the first thing he was talking to his assistant coaches, and you could hear David Joseph, Corey Joseph's dad in the background, telling him about which block they wanted to attack. But then out of that timeout, he thought that Fraser Valley would go into a zone. So he gave them a set play that they wanted to run against the zone. He was coaching one play ahead. He felt he was trying to read what Kyle Julius was doing, and he thought they were going to go zone. And it looks like they've gone man.
Baker spins onto Vivier. Wide open here. Deke Peter McNeely drains the jumper.
So they stuck to their baseline out of bounds, where they've been running very, very well. And getting a Deke on the board is really important.
4-point lead now for Edmonton, 30-26. Junior Cadogan creates some contact there. No call, Klassen. Shoots over top of South, and Klassen, boy, he has been money in this first half.
Big shot late in the clock. Good defense.
And Kemba, they're going to count it, and he'll go to the line. I thought that was going to be an offensive foul myself.
Well, I think the foul was on the drive, and then he just finished it real strong. But Matthew Kemba is a powerful player with great athleticism. He gets the foul there, but goes through the contact and completes it.
Trying to complete the three-point play.
Kemba Little scores yesterday in that victory against Ottawa. 26 points, 9 of 12 from the field. And there's Jahenz Menega. And that's what he does well, shooting that three ball.
And that's a controlled transition. Malcolm Duvivier runs the floor hard, gets to the middle, but identifies Jahenz. And there's no charge on that. Just a real good look, good pass.
And now Baker's going to come out. And Xavier Moon checks back in with 2:12 remaining in the half.
And the foul count is completely opposite this quarter than it was last quarter, with Fraser Valley with 4 and Edmonton with 0 right now.
Edmonton close to getting into the bonus. Here's Moon, and Moon drills that one for 3.
He's been shooting the ball real well. 3-point shot this entire series has been very, very good.
35-31 Edmonton. The Vivier, nice hesitation, and gets it to the rim and deposits that one.
Malcolm Duvivier is a physical shooter. He gets there, powerful 2-foot jump stop, and then he's looking for contact, and then he goes up and finishes. He did that yesterday.
Talked about it yesterday, Kyle Julius saying that he might be the most talented player on this team. Just needs to be more aggressive, and he has been. Class is trying to turn the corner. Madaga. Vivier needs some help here. Capers to set a screen. Just can't get on the inside here with this Edmonton team. Now they do, and Capers is fouled.
Great identification by Junior Cadogan on that. He knew as soon as the big came out to him that he had the mismatch inside. And Capers, I said, is long, but can jump out of the gym. And he knew he could put it anywhere, and Marcus was going to get it.
So Capers to the line here. Capers, for a number of years, was a teammate of Xavier Moon with the London Lightning and the NBLC. Vocal leader of this Fraser Valley team. And Stu Julius, who's Kyle Julius's father and assistant coach, he had to settle down Marcus Capers after he got kicked out of the game. Peter McNeely, nice move. And he'll go to the line and shoot a pair.
Yeah, great move on the isolation to get past the first line of defense. And then he drew contact with that second line of defense.
Marcus Capers, his first foul.
So Capers is going to get called for the foul, his first of the contest.
And at the line for the Stingers, number six, Sadiqa Peter McNeely.
Sadiqa Peter McNeely. Coach Small said he's probably only had one real good shooting game here, and he can shoot the ball a lot better.
But it doesn't affect the way he plays. He is a very good basketball player and a good veteran. He hasn't shot the ball anywhere near like he usually shoots it, but it doesn't affect his defense. It doesn't affect the way he communicates with his teammates.
Talked about Capers being a vocal leader. Adika Peter McNeely is that for the Edmonton side. 39 seconds now remaining in this half. 37-35 lead. Fraser Valley turn it over. Here's the big man, Daniels. And he gets the layup.
And Xavier Moon just showed you how quick he was. He was out of the play and was able to come back and grab the steal and quickly into transition.
12 seconds now remaining in the half. The Vivier. Capers. Little floater, too strong off the glass. Time running out. And that's going to do it for the first half. And I think, Joe, Fraser Valley's got to be happy just down by four after two quarters.
Oh, they've grinded, and they've got Edmonton a little frustrated. That was the first time in a long time you saw any little flow out of the Stingers.
So Capers went down hard, and he is still down. And someone's going to have to go over there and take a look at him because they can't afford to have him out of the game. And Xavier Moon, what a first half he had. 15 points in that first half. And it's going to be very tough for Fraser Valley to try to shut him down. Okay, speaking of Xavier Moon, Amy Otterbright's talking to the star of the Edmonton Stingers right now.
Yeah, thanks, Xavier. You're the top of everyone's scouting report, but you still dropped 15 in that first half. What'd you see out there?
Just got to be aggressive. We knew they were going to come out with a lot of energy, so I knew I had to be aggressive from the jump. Just got to keep it going in the second half.
In the half court, Fraser Valley's doing a heck of a job defending your bigs down low, really flustering some. So what do you tell your bigs in the locker room in the second half?
Maybe they're not scoring. They're drawing so much attention. We get it in the post, man. They just got to make the right play out of the post.
All right, thanks for your time. Good luck in the second half. Peter.
Thank you very much, Amy. So Edmonton, they lead at the half 39-35 in this championship game. On the other side, you'll hear from Andy and Javon, and they'll be talking to CEBL Commissioner Mike Morreale. Got a great game here. Stick around, folks. Two more quarters to go.
You searched a three-star hotel. You found a four-star experience. Trivago. Compare accommodation offers from the leading brands and get a great deal to maximize your budget. Hotel, vacation rental, more for less. Trivago.
My bladder leak pad? I thought it had to be Fit to Protect, but new Always Discreet is made differently. With ultra-thin layers that turn liquid to gel and lock it inside. For protection, I barely feel. New, always discreet.
Every day is sweet when we're serving you Blizzard treats. Like Smarties, Cookie Dough, Reese, and new Oreo Fudge Brownie. All made with our world-famous soft serve. Thanks for being our fans for all these years. And here's to many more. DQ. Happy tastes good.
Does scrubbing grease feel like a workout? Scrub less with Dawn Ultra. Its superior grease cleaning formula gets to work faster, making easy work of tough messes. Dawn takes care of tough grease wherever it shows up. Scrub less, save more with Dawn.
Looking for something, Jessica?
Yeah, dinner.
May I suggest Black Diamond cheese?
I love diamonds. Black Diamond.
Let's add some pepperoni, tomato sauce, and bagels. What do we have?
Dinner!
Black Diamond, since 1933.
Are your allergies keeping you from finishing the job? Try Flonase Allergy Relief. Like some pills, Flonase relieves all your worst allergy and sinus symptoms, and just one dose lasts a full 24 hours. Flonase.
Here's to the experiences we create. The moments we share. Wherever we are. San Pellegrino. Enhance your moments.
Shishito, burrito, raw kefo. Ooh. Fried shiso, french fry, iced chai, pad thai, baked pie, half stack, taco pack, lobster mac, baby back, pork chop, soda pop, kebab, soursop, hot pot. I'm hungry now. Noodle soup, cantaloupe, ice cream scoop, whipped cream, blue dumpling, chicken wing, Peking, and those crispy onion rings.
Every flavor in Canada, delivered. DoorDash.
So, what's everyone watching?
CBC Summer on CBC and CBC Gem.
Sounds so Canadian.
Next level.
It's a joke. This movie is going well.
Sure to sizzle.
It's got a bit of boom.
It's that good.
It's great.
It's huge.
So I'm in.
All summer long.
Wow.
Don't miss a moment. CBC Summer on CBC and CBC Gem.
I've been waiting for you.
It's the championship game. CEBL will be crowning a 2020 champion in less than an hour's time. You have the Bandits taking on the Stingers. Andy Petrillo alongside Javon Shepherd. And as you saw, just as that first half was ending, Marcus Capers of the Bandits goes down on the ground. He was down for a bit, but we have heard that he's gotten back up. He's gone into the room. Amy, no doubt, will be chasing down that story to see if he is still in the game for the second half. Let's begin with the Edmonton Stingers. Xavier Moon, this is a guy who's not buckling under the pressure. Spotlight's on him. He don't care. He's already put up 15 points.
You know what? Moon is doing Moon things. He's getting into the depth of the defense and the heart of the defense and making plays. He's scoring. He already has 15 points tonight, rather, you know, three away from his average. And he's really making tough shots. You know, he's made a couple tough shots as well as he had some easy shots just getting into the center of the key. One, two dribble pull up, a couple threes, and he's just making it easy on himself. Fraser Valley definitely has to do a better job of stopping that to really, you know, get him away from those easy baskets and anchoring this team. Kadugan, on the other hand, is another guy. We thought we were expecting a bit more defensively from him, but he's anchoring Fraser Valley's offense right now. He's hit a couple open threes as well. You see here, he's getting to the basket and using his body to really shield his defender and make a strong play at the basket. So, you know, we'd like to see more of him on the defensive end, and keep Xavier Moon in front of him.
Isn't that a story as old as time in sport? Nobody wants to play the defense. You want the offensive flair. But then there's the good old saying that defense is what wins you the championships. Every game, we've also talked about the Elam ending. This is going to be the final time we see that. But here we go. This is a tight game. Who do you see that favoring in the Elam ending?
You know what? This favors Fraser Valley in the ending. This is a team that 6 out of 7 games, they've won the fourth quarter by an average of 8 points. So it definitely favors them going down the stretch.
All right, well, before we get to the second half and find out who will be the ultimate champions here in 2020, the commish, Mike Morreale, he's ready to go. He'll be joining me next. Stay with us.
Does scrubbing grease feel like a workout? Scrub less with Dawn Ultra. Its superior grease cleaning formula gets to work faster, making easy work of tough messes.
Dawn is a go-to grease cleaner throughout the kitchen, too. Keep a bottle in the laundry room to pre-treat greasy stains. And keep Dawn in the garage to lift grease off car rims. It's even gentle enough to clean wildlife affected by oil. Dawn's grease cleaning power takes care of tough grease wherever it shows up. Scrub less, save more with Dawn.
This is more than just mac and cheese. This is Annie's, made from organic pasta and real white cheddar cheese. Annie's, more than just food.
2 dates, 10 peanuts, chocolate chips, and sea salt. Just 4 simple ingredients. That's all. Larabar.
My bladder leak pad? I thought it had to be thick to protect. But new Always Discreet is made differently. With ultra-thin layers that turn liquid to gel and lock it inside. For protection, I barely feel. New Always Discreet.
If we knew how many plastic bottles are thrown away every day, we would press a button.
One SodaStream bottle can save thousands of bottles.
SodaStream. Make fresh, sparkling water at home. Make a difference.
Tim Horton's Bacon Breakfast Sandwich, now even better. Our bacon is more crispy. Our English muffin is fluffy and toasty, so every bite is. Tim's Tastier Bacon Breakfast Sandwich. Come try one today.
Tired of paying too much for internet, TV, and home phone? Are bills impacting your budget? Call Comwave and join the wave. With the Comwave Power Bundle, you get a home phone line, unlimited high-speed internet, and TV with all your favorite channels, all for only $89.95 a month. Call now and get 6 months absolutely free. Be like hundreds of thousands of Canadians and join the wave.
So let me get this straight. I get a home phone line.
Unlimited internet, so no more overage charges.
TV with over 75 channels?
All for only $89.95 a month. Get unlimited internet and TV with all your favorite channels for only $89.95 a month. Call now and get 6 months free. That's right, your home phone, unlimited internet, and TV, all for 6 months absolutely free.
Now that's a great deal.
Stop paying too much. Call 1-866-503-1211 and join the wave.
Outrageous.
If you don't know who I am, you're probably going, wow, The Rock has really let himself go.
Observe it.
Are there any straight men in the audience?
Ta-da!
I figured you were here just based on some of the wardrobe choices.
And funny.
When I was on the Kids in the Hall TV show, my mom would put on both her TV sets because she thought it would improve our ratings.
It's not easy being Palestinian nowadays or for the past 7 decades.
It's normal to be tired. You don't need a 5-hour energy drink. You need to lay down once in a while.
Winnipeg Comedy Festival, tonight at 8 on CBC and CBC Gem.
We've been on this 2-week journey with the CEBL to crown a 2020 champion, a league that would normally kick off in May, but like many other leagues, was affected by COVID-19. We've been on the journey for 2 weeks, but we know it took a lot longer to plan and make sure that this summer series could come about. So let's head inside the Meridian Center in St. Catharines, Ontario. We're joined by the commissioner, Mike Morreale. Mike, can you give us a little bit of any kind of insight into what went into planning something that was 2 weeks? Catering, transportation, testing, everything.
Oh, just an incredible amount of work. It goes back probably about 8 to 10 weeks of planning, and at that time it was we had virtually no idea of what direction we were going to take or have to go, and it involved talking to multiple levels of government, multiple personnel on the health and safety side, chief medical officers of Niagara, Ontario, etc. So every little step along the way, you just kind of knock over one little roadblock to get yourself a little bit further, inch a little bit closer. But what would normally typically take 4 to 6 months to pull off an event like this, we did in about 4 to 6 weeks. So kudos to the crew and all our team that was able to shoot way above their weight, that's for sure.
Well, Mike, a Canadian pride factor, but financial factor, how important was it to also just make sure a second season happened?
Well, I think it's incredibly important to keep the brand alive. We had a tremendous year one and finished off great, and then we were trending it's such a great way. I mean, the partnership with CBC was one of the major things, adding Ottawa in the offseason, attracting top-level talent. We had a changeover about 75 new players, all of high pedigree. So getting them on a court was incredibly important. Doing it in a pandemic was difficult. But the idea was, let's get them out, let's get them playing, let's put some money in their pockets, let's get them prepared for their next season as they leave us here shortly to go overseas, and then bring them back in 2021 in a more profound way, and hopefully in front of fans.
Well, Mike, you're looking a little bit more relaxed than when we last spoke to you 2 weeks ago, but I know you have two more quarters to go before you fully exhale. We really appreciate you taking the time here. It is the championship game, and I know you're talking about Ottawa, but we also know there's expansion in the future as well. Heard some rumblings about Montreal as well in the CEBL. We have third quarter next.
This is an ad for a chip so iconic, we don't need a logo. It's a three-sided crunch. You know, that cheesy, spicy, crispy, crunchy, flavor-packed bodega snack that rhymes with, I need those. An ad with no logo? It's another level.
When you take Align, you have the support of a probiotic and the gastroenterologist who developed it.
Align helps to relieve IBS symptoms like gas, bloating, and discomfort.
So where you go, the pro goes.
Go with Align, the pros in digestive health.
Does scrubbing grease feel like a workout? Scrub less with Dawn Ultra. Its superior grease cleaning formula gets to work faster, making easy work of tough messes. Dawn takes care of tough grease wherever it shows up. Scrub less, save more with Dawn.
Here's to the experiences we create. The moments we share. Wherever we are. San Pellegrino. Enhance your moments.
At TD, we know a time will come when we'll look back and remember when life looked like this. It challenged us in ways we couldn't have imagined, but we'll also remember that something unexpected happened. What was essential to each of us came into sharp focus. We've always believed in knowing our customers personally, and now with enhanced digital banking and the support of TD Ready Advice, we're here to help you step into tomorrow feeling confident about what is essential to you. TD, ready to help you move forward.
Insalatissime Rio Mare, eating well Italian style, is easy. Only high-quality tuna, selected legumes and vegetables, many delicious recipes to eat everywhere. Insalatissime Rio Mare, real Italian taste.
Tell me about the night I was born.
Give me my baby!
Wanted to wipe us from the face of the earth. But we kept asking ourselves, why? Are we really so different?
Welcome back to the Meridian Center. I'm here with head coach Kyle Julius for the Bandits. Coach, Marcus Capers went down right at the end of the half. What's the update on him?
I think he's good to go. I think he's all right. I think he was a little bit winded. He got hit in his stomach, so I think he'll be okay.
So giving up 39 points, not too bad in the first half, but how do you score a couple more?
We got to score more. I think we were soft offensively with our decision making. We could have shot faked a few times in the paint, and I think we passed up a few open threes, and then we missed a few good ones too. So we just got to trust ourselves, trust the plan, and get back to the game plan.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Thank you. Peter, Joe?
Thank you very much, Amy. And there is the aforementioned Marcus Capers. They can't afford to have him out of this game. And as the coach said, he's ready to go. As those are the stats from the first half, what stands out for you? Obviously the Bandits got to shoot the ball better, as coach mentioned.
Yeah, but 8 games in 2 weeks. The first thing that goes for a lot of people is your legs.
and shooting, you know, if anything, being tired affects shooters. And I think what will happen now in the second half, both teams, the adrenaline will be picking up, and they'll play with adrenaline, and so that one shouldn't be a factor.
So 39-35 for Edmonton. Baker turnaround jumper, too much on that.
And forcing Jordan Baker into a post-up jump shot rather than him taking to the rim there is a win for Fraser Valley.
Luachalu, handoff to Maniga. And a foul away from the ball.
Holding foul called inside on Edmonton number 8, Jordan Baker.
So Baker, his second foul of the contest. Plenty of time on the shot clock here. Ashalu to Cadogan. Junior Cadogan had a solid first half for Fraser Valley. They'll need more of that here. Ashalu got it knocked away from him, but it's going to be Fraser Valley ball.
Good switch and compete by Jordan Baker on that one there. Went to a ball screen as Olu actually rolled to the basket. Jordan started working real hard, and they made a nice block to finish it.
3 seconds on the shot clock, and there at the depth of the shot clock, Jahenz Maniga.
Good out of bounds, good recognition.
As we mentioned in the first half, struggled from three yesterday, but he's knocked down a couple of threes here late in the first half and early here in the second half. Edmonton will retain possession here.
That's a good sign for Edmonton. An offensive rebound. They only got two in that first half, and that's a big part of their game.
You see Travis Daniels had 6 points in that first half, go along with three boards. Diawara sends it up high for Xavier Moon. Xavier Moon, oh, he broke the ankles on Cadogan, missed the three. And then they clean up on the glass, and that's Travis Daniels.
A second offensive rebound in one possession. But what a move by Xavier Moon.
Crossed them up big time. Here's Maniga. Pocket pass for Ashalu, able to save him, but then gave it away. Pass inside, Baker, window and in.
Great play, lots of people touching the basketball, space the floor, then attack the middle. But Xavier Daniels, the threat of him defensively has become a factor.
Maniga, he'll go cross court for Capers. DeVivier, off the rim. And now Edmonton in the open court.
And good move by Mom. Good move by Mom behind that one there. Look at this move. It's almost like Junior looked for the drive and got caught. That one hurt.
Yeah. But that's what Xavier Moon could do. I mean, to the best of defenders.
Then they spread the floor and they find the fourth man, in this case, Jordan Baker, with his first field goal of the game. And that's important because that gets him off.
43-38 for Edmonton. Diawara dishes it off. Easy bucket there for Travis Daniels.
Coach Smalls is happy because Edmonton now is getting to score at the rim, and this is what they didn't get in the first half outside of Xavier Moon.
DeVivier launches one, and DeVivier comes up big, knocking down a triple.
Nice set. Good screen, and Malcolm DeVivier sprinted over there, lost his man, and knocks down the open shot.
Moon, some more acrobatics there. And Moon is going to go to the line here.
Foul called inside. The Bandits number 11, Malcolm DeVivier.
So that's going to go against DeVivier, and that's his first of the game.
Substitution now for Fraser Valley.
Scoring leaders in this summer series. And you had Cameron Forte, who's at the top of that list. Obviously, he was let go by Fraser Valley. Xavier Moon, 17.9 points going into this one. A big-time score for this Edmonton team. And see Thomas Scrubb. We saw him yesterday. His Ottawa team, expansion team, losing in the semifinals.
And the incredible thing about Xavier Moon is he scores when he has to score. You know, he will still facilitate first.
Fraser Valley team sticking around here, down by six. Dugan to swing it around. DeVivier puts it on the deck, stops up. Little fadeaway, missed that one.
And that's Travis Daniels' length again, becoming a factor in here.
Yesterday they had a size disadvantage. Fraser Valley did with Hamilton. Is this size disadvantage a little bit different here with Edmonton?
It is, but Travis Daniels now is starting to close the gap on that. He's just playing much, much bigger.
And there you go. Another bucket for the big man.
They've done a great job the second half of establishing their inside presence.
A couple of crossovers there from DeVivier. Kyle Johnson tries the jumper. And no, nothing going here. Last couple of sequences down the court for Fraser Valley. Here's Kamba. That's a rare miss. He thought he was fouled.
So all the second half, they've done a good job of putting the ball inside. Daniels gets in there, Reed probes, and gets it over to his left shoulder where he's been very effective.
You see his numbers so far this afternoon, 12 points, 6 of 8 from the field, 5 boards.
And his plus minus, he was leading at with 12 going into halftime. He was the one person on the court that was making having an effect on both ends. That last shot was a tip, so they're calling it stinger ball.
So Baker with the inbounds. There's Brody Clark. Ambe Diawara. Diawara tried to swing it for Baker. That almost went out of bounds, but there's Moon to save the day, and his pass inside. It goes off of Knicks. 2 seconds on the shot clock here.
Very similar situation that we had down the other end when they scored on the short clock on the baseline out of bounds.
So Deka Peter-McNeely will come in. Mambe Diawara, former University of Calgary Dino, he'll take a seat. They need a catch and shoot here. And they threw it away. Jermaine Smalls put his hands up to his head. He's a little ticked off.
And it was a look for Brody Clark. It was a Jordan Baker thought he had made eye contact with Brody, and it was just a quick look to him. And he caught Brody by surprise.
Kyle Johnson. Going to be a foul on Tavarian Nix.
Jordan,
away from the ball.
Jordan Baker starting to make his presence known. And this is what he does. He makes a good read here. He claims the position, is not going to give it up. And Nix goes right through him. Easy, and it's a big turnover. Good charge, but a big turnover.
Fraser Valley, they want to press a little bit here. He comes into the game. Post up now for Brody Clark. Bumping there with Nix. Turn around. And a foul against Nix.
And Nix got his two hands on Brody Clark there. And I think that's where the foul is. He was taking the contact, but he was giving it back. If you can hold the arm bar, you're good. He got the second hand on him.
His second team's fourth.
Clark, jumper, and they're just cleaning up on the glass here this afternoon, and that was Kamba.
Yeah. Refer to him as Kamba Slice. I was going to call him, you know, Matthew Air Kamba on that. He's been great off of his ability to get up off of 2 feet and just hang in the air. Watch the competition factor of Matthew Kamba inside when he gets an opportunity to go to the rim with it, even as a rebounder. They run the set play. He goes for the offensive board, but it's just his lift. It's a powerful lift. You don't put a body on him, he's above you.
And that's the one area that Kyle Julius talked about. We have to equal them in terms of rebounding the ball, boxing out. So Junior Cadogan to the line here. He went for a little bit of a spill underneath the bucket.
And that's easier said than done, because when you get Olu Ashlu off the floor, who's your physical presence, you're playing with undersized four men. And so keeping the only way that you can keep them off the glass is you must be physical on every possession.
Lead widening a little bit here for Edmonton, 51-43. Peter McNeely, Kareem South, Clark down. Clark trying to get inside, and a hook shot, and sinks it.
The adjustment by Coach Small at halftime has been very important here, because he's now declared himself an inside presence.
Knicks driving to the tin. They wipe out the bucket. It'll be a foul against Edmonton, but they're going to call it on the floor. It's going to go against Kareem Self. So right now, you've got Edmonton up by 10. Brody Clark leading the way for Edmonton.
Foul was called on Edmonton's number.
Tim's camps can be life-changing for youth who need it most. This summer, we're coming together virtually.
At Tim's Camp, everyone always supports each other, no matter what walk of life they come from. On August 12th, buy a coffee, change a life.
You try to stay ahead of the mess, but scrubbing still takes time. Now there's Dawn Power Wash Dish Spray. It's the faster way to clean as you go. Just spray, wipe, and rinse. It cleans grease five times faster. Dawn Power Wash. Spray, wipe, rinse.
This is an ad for a chip so iconic, we don't need a logo. It's a three-sided crunch. You know, that cheesy, spicy, crispy, crunchy, flavor-packed bodega snack that rhymes with, I need those. An ad with no logo? It's another level.
Canada Deposit Insurance Corporation is a federal agency that protects your money when you deposit it with any of our member institutions. Look for our logo, however you bank. CDIC, see how we protect your money.
Brody Clark, 6'8 forward, Edmonton Stingers. University of Alberta, Toronto, Ontario. Big shout out to my mom and dad for being my number one fans.
And there you see DJ Four Corners providing some entertainment here at the Meridian Center. As it is now 53-43 in favor of Edmonton. And you just saw Brody Clark there, the profile on him. His dad was a national team member. His mom was a pretty good basketball player in her own right. He's got a brother that was an outstanding basketball, and he's got a sister who was a rower. You talk about athletic genes in that family.
Brody's had a great career at the University of Alberta, and stepping in here as a graduated U Sport player, the experience he got last year in the CEBL has really helped him this year.
I saw him 2 years ago at the U Sport Nationals in Halifax. Very impressed with him. He was the leader of that University of Alberta team, and it's really not shocking he's adapted to the pro game.
And former player of the year at the U Sports level. Did a nice job of drawing the foul there. This Edmonton Stingers team, this half, has already got five offensive rebounds, one more than they had the entire first half.
Adika Peter McNeely knocking down a tray.
And a two-pass direct attack on the zone, getting it to the middle.
And then a turnover by Fraser Valley. And Fraser Valley's got to be careful. Things don't come off the rails here. Here, Self misses it. Kyle Johnson has the board. Klassen, who had a strong first half, gives way to Johnson. Curl, but he can't drive. Shot clock winding down to Vivier. wants to drive, gets it inside, and Olu Asolu gets the bucket. They needed that one, Joe.
Great job by Malcolm Duvier to find there, and Edmonton was real close. They were rotating down and just missed that. Their defense has improved, and they're forcing Fraser Valley to use their best to score.
Boom. Jumper from the free throw line, no problem.
His free throw line jumper has turned around to be somebody else's layup. He is incredible. I don't know if I've seen him miss in the series yet.
His accuracy has just been phenomenal in this summer series. Duvivier rises up for three. So back-to-back trips down offensively. And Fraser Valley able to get points.
And good recognition by Johannes Maniga. Olu Ashlu was working in there. They drew some help and left Malcolm open.
And then Brody Clark, he's starting to get his game in order. Kyle Julius, timeout call. And they have to find some answers here offensively, Joe.
Yeah, but they have to find some answers defensively, too. And that's what Fraser Valley does. They want to make sure that they stop you on defense, and that creates their offense. But if they're going to trade baskets, they're going to lose that game. They need to create something off the defensive end. And this run right now by Edmonton is affecting Fraser Valley.
And they have been monsters on the offensive glass here this afternoon. That's been a big difference.
So Xavier Moon shows you there what he can do with the crossover. And there's always the threat that he's going to the basket. So you have to be careful. And then when he gets an opportunity, or this one here on the tip, this is the combo tip. So you're watching the five offensive rebounds in this second half that have already surpassed what they did in the first half, and they've turned into points. And this is the play that Edmonton needs to compete against the Bandits.
Does this go back to the size mismatch, or is it more than just the size mismatch?
It's now them using their size. In the first half, Fraser Valley dictated the fact that we're not going to let you inside. And now they're establishing themselves inside. Maybe they didn't show enough respect for the Bandits in the first half, but now it's a focus of what they want to do is put the ball inside.
Kyle Julius, after this summer series, he heads to Asia, to Taipei, coaches a team in Taiwan, the Formosa Dreamers. While he's preparing these games late at night, he's helping to prepare the games for the Formosa Dreamers via Skype and Zoom. So he's basically coaching two teams.
That's an easy career.
But he seems to be a man that can't get enough of basketball. Right now, he's got to find a way to get his team back into this one, down by 12.
And that's a good start off a nice ball screen action. Find Olu Asolu rolling to the basket, putting the ball in his hands where he's got a chance to attack the rim.
Making the first of two.
And on that last attack, Olu made sure that he drew contact.
An eight-year pro, played in Japan, played professionally in Canada.
Made the big Elam ending winning shot in yesterday's game against Hamilton.
There's Kareem Self. Kyle Johnson trying to defend him. Clark again, in the post, Clark. Six on the shot clock. Leave the bucket off. It's going to be a foul against Duvivier.
And Clark's going to the line for two. And that's an offense where Edmonton scores. And Xavier Moon doesn't touch the ball.
So now Edmonton, they're into the bonus. We've got 2:13 remaining in the third quarter.
Brody Clark's done a real good job of getting inside, getting Fraser Valley into the situation where they have to foul. Now that's the bonus, and that's part of the attack inside.
To Hans Menega, Klassen inside, Olu Asolu, no. Rolls off the rim. Good sequence, though, there from Fraser Valley. Something to build on. Moon. On the drive. Hit the side of the backboard. And it's going to be a foul, an offensive foul against Moon.
It's one of the few times where Xavier Moon gives it away what he's going to do early. And Johannes Maniga, who's been the leader in steals for the Bandits, now causes another turnover.
These two teams opened up the summer series. 113-100 victory for Fraser Valley. Play whistled down. Coach Julius said he didn't even bother watching the tape of that game. He said that was so long ago, forgotten that. As we mentioned, their team changed a little bit with Forte leaving the team.
His third foul. Self is replaced by Matthew Kemba.
Fraser Valley's been here before. Yesterday they were down 13 in the fourth. And what they did was they used their defense to create stops and then just chipped away on the offense, got to the free throw line, made, you know, timely baskets, didn't force anything. And they're smart enough to know that right now, that they're still in this game.
Down 62-51. Plenty of basketball left here. 1:30 remaining in the third. Again, a press here from Fraser Valley.
And all they're trying to do here is just wear some of the clock out.
As Peter McNeely turns the corner on Medica. Hoop in the arm. No. Yes, it is the hoop in the arm. And Peter McNeely will go to the line.
Yeah, and that started with a little bad risk-reward situation. Johannes trying to draw the charge. It got beat. And all of a sudden, rotation wasn't there. And it surprised everybody. Great job by Dika. Really important. He's knocked down a three now. He's got a three-point play. This is what Coach Smalls was talking about, the confidence he has in Adika Peter McNeely. He knew that he was going to come and give him something today.
Talked about Brody Clark coming from a basketball family. Adika Peter McNeely, his brother Jay, head coach at Seneca College in Toronto, a CCAA team. So now 65-52 for Edmonton. Behind the back by DeVivier, and then he loses the handle, goes to the deck, can't get the ball. They push it up for Baker, and Baker, he tried to feed Kemba, and he went right into our cameraman down there.
Good transition, but watch Merrick Clausen just get back. He does a great job of getting back. The second time now that he's broken up a transition situation by his hustle.
And this is our cameraman, Alex, down there, right into your living room, folks. And Kemba getting up a little slowly there. Seems to be okay, stays in the game. Under a minute now in this third quarter. Olu Asholu. Underneath the bucket here. And he got pushed up by Brody Clark.
Looked like good defense by Brody Clark initially. He put Olu Asholu in jail. And then
pushing foul underneath Paul Lyle.
Maybe because he gave him a push.
14, so Clark, his second foul.
Asholu will go to the line. Second foul.
Olu Asholu shooting two.
Going against Clark, both teams into the bonus with 46.3 seconds remaining.
With 46.3 remaining, you're going to find Edmonton more than likely is going to look for 2-for-1. And what they're talking about is 2-for-1, get two shots off in the 46 seconds, getting one possession, defending, and then finishing the quarter with their second possession.
They get the board there on the miss on that second free throw attempt. Kyle Johnson, and then keepers off the feed, throws it down.
And that started with the offensive rebound off the missed free throw.
So now it's a 10-point lead for Edmonton. That pass is no good. Klassen, he wants to slow it down. 16 seconds now remaining in the third. This will give this Fraser Valley team a big boost of confidence if they can get a bucket here before the quarter ends. Here's Johnson, and that's blocked by Xavier Moon, but Moon is going to get called for the foul.
Good screen for Kyle Johnson there. Xavier Moon came in with the left hand. Reacted late, came in with the left hand.
Kyle Johnson at the line.
Just got a piece of him. But these 46 seconds that we talked about in the last free throw when they were here, Edmonton missed the rebound, gave up a two, go down, and then allows Fraser Valley to come back and score the last points of the quarter. So where they were in control, they lost a little bit there. Not a good finish for Edmonton in Coach Small's mind.
So Johnson gets the second. Not a lot of time left. And boy, we're going to have a good finish here. Fraser Valley came on towards the end of that third quarter. And after three quarters of play, Edmonton, Xavier Moon, Baker and company in front, 65-56. We'll come back. Fourth quarter action. CEBL title on the line.
This is an ad for a chip so iconic, we don't need a logo. It's the three-sided crunch. You know, that cheesy, spicy, crispy, crunchy, flavor-packed bodega snack that rhymes with, I need those. An ad with no logo? It's another level.
My bladder leak pad? I thought it had to be thick to protect. But new Always Discreet is made differently. With ultra-thin layers that turn liquid to gel and lock it inside. For protection, I barely feel. New Always Discreet.
New Microband 24. Watch as Microband 24 kills 99.9% of bacteria. And then, even after multiple touches, keeps killing bacteria for 24 hours. I trust Microband 24 to keep killing bacteria for 24 hours.
Everybody, you've got to tip your hat to this man here. Travis Daniels' sister passed away last week. He's had a real tough life. Mom suffered from mental illness, went from group home to other family members living with them, was saved by basketball, and the nation getting a chance here on a national stage to watch him play. How he's been able to do this, I have no idea. But this guy is mentally tough, and he's been a big part of this Edmonton team, Joe.
In this second half particularly, he influenced a bunch of shots on defense because of his defense, and then on offense, he set the tone real early of getting the ball inside and attacking the rim with it.
He decided he wanted to stay with his team here. His sister's funeral was yesterday. So again, we pass on our condolences to the Daniels family. And we're underway, fourth quarter action, 65-56 for Edmonton. And Kyle Johnson opens up the frame with a nice jumper.
When you put a shooter on the free throw line and then let him get outside and shoot the ball, Kyle Johnson now is going to find himself.
This game is far from over, 65-58. Peter McNeely, jump back three, step back three, excuse me. Can't make it, left it short. Here's Klassen. No look feed. Oluwaseulu gets it back again. And boy, he did some heavy lifting in the paint. And is fouled, and he'll go to the line.
Yeah, great offensive rebound by Olu, and he knew that when he missed the shot. So Oluwaseulu goes hard for it on the drive, knows he's going to miss it, and he just keeps fighting for it. He knew it was off. Great rebound. Gets rewarded.
And in just a second here, Mombe Diawara will check back in for Edmonton. Try to change things up a little bit for the Stingers.
It's nice when you have a big man shooting 87% from the free throw line.
Checking back into the game for the Stingers, replacing.
Able to make both. And now that Edmonton lead is just five.
Two very good possessions right there for the Bandits coming out of that timeout.
Diawara being hounded by Kyle Johnson. Diawara driving, gets met there by Oluwaseulu. Good defense. Edmonton gets the ball again, though.
6 seconds on the shot clock, and again defended by Capers. And Baker can't convert. Who's got it? That's going to be Edmonton ball, but some good defense there from Fraser Valley.
Real good, real solid defense here. They rotate over. Next man out. They do a good job on the closeout. Good tack by Jordan Baker.
Don't sweat. Baker looking for options here. He's going to shoot the jumper. And now you get the sense Fraser Valley got their confidence back again.
Edmonton had two poor possessions spacing-wise. Not what they were doing early in the second half.
Second chance opportunity here. Capers. Johnson. Being defended there by Diawara. Shoots over top of Diawara. And Edmonton, they'll push it up the court. Pass here for Kemba. Kemba trying to feed Daniels, and Kemba's going to get charged with an offensive foul.
Malcolm Duvivier gets back on defense, and he's playing Kemba to drive all the way. If Kemba slices off that and throws the alley-oop up, Daniels finishes, but Duvivier played Kemba to drive all the way. Good defense.
Lassen will bring it over the timeline. Lassen wide open. Can't make the three.
But that's a communication breakdown by Edmonton.
Daniels running the floor there. Diawara. Clark sets a screen. Four on the shot clock. Diawara, that's a deep three. Missed it. And Klassen picks it up. Merrick Klassen wants to drive. Klassen, high glass, no good.
What you get with Bobby Diawara is offense, but sometimes what he does is he stops the flow of your offense because he's a scorer and he's always looking to score.
Got a number of players like Diawara can do a multitude of things on this Stingers roster. Here's Diawara. Tried to feed it, tried to force one. Capers says thank you very much. Here's Klassen, no look feed. They kick it out. Duvivier misses.
And Edmonton again fortunate. You can't pause the ball on offense where you're making everybody stand still on defense because the defense gets the advantage.
Junior Cadogan and company trying to get back into this one. Down by five. Back.
This year, my family didn't go abroad.
My parents and I were just a few hours from home.
My mom found a place on Trivago. It was the best time of my life. Because I met Lisa.
Because I met Ben.
Find more than what you're searching for. Trivago. Compare accommodation offers from the leading brands and find the best deal for you. Hotel, vacation rental, and much more. Trivago.
Struggling to clean tough messes with wipes? Try Mr. Clean Magic Eraser Sheets. Just wet, squeeze, and erase icky messes in microwaves and on stovetops. For an amazing clean, get the power of Mr. Clean Magic Eraser in disposable sheets.
I find for most people that sensitivity is real, and if you're not doing anything to address the problem, the condition of sensitivity can get worse. My recommendation, Sensodyne, always. There's really no reason to ignore it. Sensodyne works. It's such a simple fix.
Jermaine Small telling his team, hey, just chill out a bit here, folks.
Calm down. We're losing our heads. Calm down, guys.
Because of fake pressure, though. That shit fake. They've been doing it the whole game. Oh,
crazy. Now we're reacting to every call being made. That's not who we are. Poise and composure. Calm down. I don't want to see you.
Yes, chill out. It's only a championship game. Relax a little bit.
Yeah, he's getting his guys to refocus because they've spent too much time worrying about the last call. And now they've got this run that they've got to be able to answer against.
Remains small, plenty of experience. He's the head coach of the University of Lethbridge, was an assistant at Queens, an assistant under Roy Ranna at Ryerson. He knows how to run a team. He's done a great job here with his Edmonton team. There you go. Calm down. Brody Clark gets the bucket.
So Edmonton has two players, and Daniels and Brody Clark right now, who can post up, and they're just going through the best match that they have.
7-point lead now for Edmonton. 6:29 remaining. Just a reminder, folks, we'll have an Elam ending. Oluwaseulu can't finish, but he's hacked. Daniels, he's got a sarcastic smile on his face as he's being called for the foul.
And you know Olu's going to finish at the rim. You know, and early in the first half, I thought Edmonton did a great job of bluffing. And now Olu knows that nobody's coming, so he's just getting to Daniels' body and trying to extend himself with that right hand.
Olu's made a number of trips here in the second half to the free throw line. Team shot from the charity stripe poorly yesterday, 65%. And now a little discussion here. Somebody must have jumped in to the lane.
It looked like the violation was from the perimeter. Now in FIBA, if the violation is from the offensive team and the ball goes in, it still counts.
Fraser Valley a lot better here this afternoon from the free throw line. Shooting over 80%. Moon rises up and drains a three.
Great read by Xavier Moon to back cut from the half court to get himself open for a three.
8-point lead now. 70-62. To Dugan. To Dugan. Wants to drive. This is the mark there. Kamba. He gets surrounded by a couple of Fraser Valley players.
And what Fraser Valley has been very good this entire series is on those drives, they haven't forced it. They've been able to stop, relocate, find the open person on the outside. In that case, Junior was going up against guys with a lot more length than him.
Johannes Maniga replaces Junior Cadugan.
Maniga will come in. Junior Cadugan has done stellar work here this afternoon. He'll take a bit of a rest. This is still in the ballpark here for Fraser Valley. Moon. Deacon Peter McNeely going baseline in the corner, moving that rock around. They go cross court. Daniels for three, no misses. Get an offensive board. Kamba, Peter McNeely, and this time they drain it. Boy, they move that ball around so efficiently, Joe.
When you move the ball around, you move the defense around. So when you do that, you take a shot, all of a sudden now, you've got better offensive rebounding situations.
And now an offensive foul against Johannes Maniga.
So the ball gets moved, the defense is forced to move. And when the defense moves, you watch the offensive rebound set up. Kamba goes down, gets it, kicks out, and now you've got Adika Peter McNeely, who is here.
I would think that Coach Jermaine Small is happy with his performance here this afternoon. Not that he had a bad performance yesterday, but shooting the ball much better here.
And this is Stinger basketball. Playing at a little crisper speed right now, and Xavier Moon there setting himself up for that nice little pull-up.
And that ball spotted away by Kamba, and that pumps up everybody in those gold jerseys.
Matthew Kamba has had a coming-out party this entire series. This looks like he's got the shot off for sure. And Kamba gets out there, no foul, just gets out there. Great block, tough block.
And everybody, and you see Capos pumped up. Everybody rising up from that bench. And now Kyle Julius has to figure something out here with time running down on this Fraser Valley team, albeit We're going to get to Elam time, and Elam time has been very good for Fraser Valley.
Yeah, and the good thing that Coach Julius has in his pocket when he goes into that timeout is we've been here before. He can remind them that they've been there before, that they were there yesterday. We came back, and we played a strong finish to get ourselves to Elam first, and then in Elam we took over. So right now, his focus is get to Elam by playing great basketball.
The bracket for this summer series. Yesterday, Stingers got by Ottawa. Ottawa, a tired team, 4 games in 5 days. And then you had Hamilton. It looked like Hamilton was going to be in this championship game for the second year in a row. They did not manage Elam time properly. And Fraser Valley is here. And it's 75-62, and we're getting close to Elam time. 4:54 remaining. Kadugan, his shot no good. Xavier Moon, he has 24 points. And that ties a record for most points in a CEBL championship game. Brody Clark knocking down the jumper.
Good set there off a little flex screen, posting up Brody Clark. They have stayed with the post up the entire half.
Kadugan. Oshalu trying to muscle his way in there. And Olu Oshalu going to go back to the line again. He's made a steady trip to the line here in this second half.
And Coach Smalls is okay with that, because what he doesn't want, he doesn't want the ball to go in and then go out for a three. So when the ball went to Olu Oshalu there, he's okay with the foul. He's okay with the two-pointer. He doesn't want it to come out and get swung around for a three.
That bucket that Brody Clark had, that gives him 14. Moon has 24. And Adika Peter McNeely, 13 points in this game, as he is 4 of 10 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3. And Olu Oshalu getting the job done at the free throw line. 77-63. There's some up-court pressure from Fraser Valley. Edmonton able to break out of it.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to break pressure when you get the ball back from Xavier Moon.
Yeah, with his speed. There's Moon, deep three, and Moon sinks it. He's been doing that throughout this summer series. He's made it look easy, Joe.
Absolutely, and when he had the match on him, of Olu Oshalu on him, his eyes got big.
Kadugan wants the drive, stopped up by Baker. Pass for Olu Oshalu, no good. Peter McNeely misses. Kamba in there. Wow, they're playing volleyball there as Baker batted that back to Moon.
It started with Kamba coming from the perimeter.
Moon. Pass down low, and Baker is fouled. And he'll head to the line. And now you're starting to see Edmonton impose their will in this game, Joe.
Absolutely. And Jordan Baker did a great job of sealing the position in there. Hadn't scored a whole lot, but knew right then and there, if I'd seal, they're going to foul. And it looked like he could have drawn, actually, an unsportsmanlike. I don't think it was called that, but it looked like he was in position. He had buried Malcolm DeVivier.
A little bit of a delay here. As we wait for Baker to shoot a pair. Time running down here on this Fraser Valley team. They got it going a little bit there in the fourth quarter, Joe. And then, like I said, this Edmonton team, they decided to change the gears on them.
Yeah, and they just stayed with their plan. They made a quick adjustment here. So this basket's important, because the maker missed. Now we got to decide what Elam's target score is. So it's 81 plus the 9. So our target score is going to be 90. And now that's been determined after that free throw.
And there you take a look at the trophy. One last season by Saskatchewan. Saskatchewan surprised everybody. They beat Hamilton in the final. Everybody thought that it was going to be an Edmonton-Niagara final. That didn't materialize. And that is a beautiful trophy. And that's Dr. Mike Terrigan. He's the chief medical officer for the CEBL and a guy that really helped them figure out how they were going to put this tournament on in the time of COVID. And he might be the real MVP of this CEBL Summer Series.
Well, I think the entire plan is the MVP. And the idea that the medical component of this in the COVID attack was handled by Niagara Public Health. So it wasn't the league involved in that. And that's really important because they had great partnerships with the provincial government, the federal government, and the civic government.
And I mentioned it yesterday when I talked to Mike Morreale. This tournament, Summer Series, excellent. I mean, and the staff, and they pulled people from different teams to help out for this series. You couldn't find a more cooperative group. If you needed something, you got it. And I mean, they just worked very hard to put this off, and they made my job, your job, our entire staff, Amy's job, so much easier. And hats off to this league for putting on this Summer Series. They've done a fantastic job, and they should be very proud of what they've done here. Okay, Elam ending. We've explained it every game. We need to explain it. Some people are still not too sure about it. So here you go, Joe.
You add 9 points to this team that's leading. That becomes the target score. First team to the target score wins. And we've had a bunch of different ways a team have won, with threes, with twos, with ones. The key in Elam time we found was play your game. Don't try to win it with an Elam winner. Play your game and good things will happen.
So the target is 90. And a travel against Fraser Valley.
And look at Edmonton's defense on that. They collapsed in the middle, but everybody shot out knowing that Junior Cadogan was driving to be a passer rather than be a scorer.
Fraser Valley presses, and once again, Edmonton able to break out of it. Here's Xavier Moon. Just take his time here. Moon wants another three. Missed that one. Baker moves in there. He got the rebound. How he got that rebound, there were two Fraser Valley players there, Joe. He just split them and wanted that ball.
And both players were trying to rebound, but nobody boxed out Jordan Baker. If you don't put a body on him, that's just a free lane for him to come in, and he'll put his body on you.
Led this Summer Series in rebounding. It's the first of two. Wayne Smalley took over this team from Coach Craddock, who coaches at University of Alberta, Barnaby Craddock. Just too much on his plate. Small comes in, and this team didn't miss a beat. Here's Capers. He gets knocked down.
It gets away with a quick hook there.
Edmonton foul was called.
Gets himself to the rim. Now, the one thing you'll find with Elam time, if you're the team that's losing, so if this was a regular game, and we've got a 19-point spread with under 4 minutes, in this case, under 3 minutes, the chance of Fraser Valley coming back is minimal or none. So what are you going to get? You're going to get hack-a-shack. You're going to get, a slow-up timeout game. It's just going to draw. Here, because the clock's gone, this is your greatest chance. All of a sudden, the chance of victory becomes greater than it was. It's not by any means high in numbers, but it's much better chance for a team that's behind to win in Elam time than it is in a regular game.
And if you talk to the coaches, they're not too fussy about Elam time, but, you know, in the case of Kyle Julius, they've had success in Elam time.
I think most people aren't fussy until they
see it, exactly,
and become a part of it, and then they realize how much they like it.
There's Baker to the 10, and then backing him up is the big man, Travis Daniels.
And the nice thing what Edmonton's doing now, this is not a press break. This is a press attack. They went with five guys down court, north and south, passed the ball and attacked the basket and finished it off with a rebound.
84-65, Edmonton. 6 points away from winning a CEBL championship. Four on the shot clock from the corner. Dugan gets it to go. Got the roll to go for him. And Cadogan puts the shoulder into Moon. Foul against Junior Cadogan.
And that was just to stop transition. But here in Elam time with the bonus. So you look at them running. They move the ball, they spread, they find their guys inside position. Travis Daniels, they use their size. They've used their size the whole second half, and that's been the difference.
Now Moon to the line. There you see the numbers. 27 points, 11 of 14 from the field.
And 8 games in 2 weeks is tough. His aerobic capacity is through the roof. Over the moon, maybe.
Over the moon. There you go. Nobody runs as much as Xavier Moon. Here's Capers going coast to coast. And now Moon once again. Moon in trouble. Gets trapped. Peter McNeely baseline for Jordan Baker. Short little baseline. Jimmy sinks it. And now Edmonton on the verge here. Wide open, Jens Medica, a fake, and knocking it down.
Medica with the
Fraser
ball.
Valley team, Joe, they don't quit.
Have it all series.
Play whistled down. That's going to be a foul on Kyle Johnson.
So you've got a 15-point lead, and all the pressure now is on Xavier Moon to knock them both down.
So here we go, Xavier Moon can end this game and bring a CEBL championship to Edmonton. And it's only fitting that he be the man to do so. So 1 point away, and players are up on the bench here. And Jermaine Small, the right of me here, hugs his assistant coach. And that's it. And the Edmonton Stingers come out on top. They were expected to get to the final last year. They were upset. They came back, brought most of the players from last year's team, and Jermaine Small, he had a game plan, and that game plan worked, Joe.
It really did, and in the second half adjustment of getting big again, I thought was a huge move, and Adika Peter McNeely just gave them a little bit more than they needed in the first half, and then you got Xavier Moon for the entire game.
Xavier Moon was outstanding. Adika Peter McNeely had talked to Coach Small. I met him downtown, bumped into him downtown. I said, what's going on with a Deacon? He said, he has not shot the ball well. Well, boy, last couple of games, he's really performed. And this whole team has performed. They've had so much depth and well deserving of the CEBL title. And there is Xavier Moon. Going to get a lot of consideration for the MVP of the championship game, I would think. And see him with Jahens Medega. And there is Jermaine Small. Thursday, I went to practice, and they weren't paying attention. They had that long layoff. And boy, he blew the whistle and just took a strip off this team and got their attention. I stayed for another 10 minutes of practice, and the pace in practice was just crazy. They got vocal, they started communicating. They got snapped back into shape, I guess you could say. And it results here, a win yesterday against Ottawa, and now they win the championship.
And their time off, they used it to prepare. And in that second half, guys stepped up. You know, Matthew Kamba, offensive rebounds were huge. But Travis Daniels started in the second half.
Let's show you how the game ends as that man right there, Xavier Moon, went to the line. And there you go.
front of us is the Edmonton team celebrating. There you see them coming off the bench. And, you know, for these guys who, some of these guys are playing in Europe, playing in other leagues, the season gets shut down because of COVID. This has got to be a happy ending here to get a chance to play for something.
You didn't think we were going to see basketball
exactly.
for a long time. And everybody bought in. The players bought in. The organization did a great job of setting it up, but it's the players who bought in and believed in it. And we had some of the best talent in Canada. And this team has just gotten better over 2 years. So a credit to the Edmonton Stinger organization, Coach Smalls, and his entire staff.
Well, Joe, hey, it's been a pleasure to work with you. Thank you, my friend. Outstanding. Hope we can do it again. Time for us to take a break. Edmonton wins the title. On the other side, you'll hear from Andy and Javon.
Canada Deposit Insurance Corporation is a federal agency that protects your money when you deposit it with any of our member institutions. Look for our logo, however you bank. CDIC, see how we protect your money.
You try to stay ahead of the mess, but scrubbing still takes time. Now there's Dawn Power Wash Dish Spray. It's the faster way to clean as you go. Just spray, wipe, and rinse. It cleans grease 5 times faster. Dawn Power Wash. Spray, wipe, rinse.
Are your allergies keeping you from finishing the job? Try Flonase Allergy Relief. Like some pills, Flonase relieves all your worst allergy and sinus symptoms. And just one dose lasts a full 24 hours. Flonase.
With Insalatissime Rio Mare, eating well Italian style is easy. Only high-quality tuna, selected legumes and vegetables, many delicious recipes to eat everywhere. Insalatissime Rio Mare, real Italian taste.
Make every visit count with new Tim's Rewards Points. Just download the Tim Hortons app and tap into more rewards choices, like breakfast sandwiches, ice caps, and more. Plus, get exclusive offers. Tap into more Tim's Rewards. Download the app.
Shining down on me. Here I go, I'm coming for you. Can't nothing stop me. I got some things I gotta do. I'm making a move. Study long, study wrong. Ain't nothing gonna happen.
For everyone going back to school, we've got your back with low prices. Walmart. Save money, live better.
This is an athlete 20 reps deep sprinting past every leak in our softest, smoothest fabric. She's confident, protected, her strength respected. Depend, the only thing stronger than us is you.
Behind every young Canadian athlete is a fiercely dedicated coach.
Wake up, let's go!
Petro-Canada's FACE program provides funding to Canada's aspiring athletes and their coaches, which helps strengthen these bonds.
Yeah, tiny, tiny bit on the bottom. One more.
Hear their stories at cbcsports.ca/thebond. The Bond, brought to you by Petro-Canada. For Petro-Canada to live by the leaf, means supporting those who wear it.
Keeping your smile healthy between dental visits is important. The Waterpik Water Flosser removes plaque from treated areas. Brushing alone only gets the surface, but the Waterpik Water Flosser cleans the areas brushing may miss. Go to waterpik.ca to learn more.
This is an ad for a chip so iconic, we don't need a logo. It's the three-sided crunch. You know, that cheesy, spicy, crispy, crunchy, flavor-packed bodega snack that rhymes with,
I need those.
An ad with no logo? It's another level.
Together, we're making a difference to stop the spread of COVID-19. As businesses reopen, practice physical distancing, and wear face coverings where distancing is a challenge. To find out more, visit ontario.ca/coronavirus.
The summer savings event at Leon's is held over. Get special prices throughout the showroom. Plus, save up to 50% on bedroom furniture. And take 2 years to pay with 0% interest. Leon's summer savings event is held over until Wednesday. Visit leons.ca for details.
Hey, baby.
Hi.
Welcome to paradise.
Mayday, mayday. I think something has happened to my husband.
Was everything all right when you first arrived?
Yeah, it was fine.
Maggie, you need to tell me everything.
The Sounds, this fall on CBC and CBC Gem.
Tonight, the emergence of new realities, a new normal, new fears, new hopes, CBC News delivers the latest information you need to navigate these times. Join us tonight on The National.
Xavier Moon, the hero for the Edmonton Stingers, he gets that winning free throw. As you know, the target score in Elam, 90-73 over the Fraser Valley Bandits. They are the 2020 CEBL champions as we welcome you inside our CBC Sports Studios. There you go, the Stingers, they stand alone. Seven teams, then there were four, then there were two, and then just one, Annie Petrillo, Javon Shepherd. Alex Campbell was the MVP for the final game last year. You wonder if it's going to be Xavier Moon here today. 31 points. We'll get to that in just a second. But, you know, Fraser Valley was priding themselves almost on this David and Goliath matchup throughout the whole summer series. It worked in their favor, but this time it seemed like Edmonton was just too big of a giant this time around.
And you know what? Edmonton deserved this. They're a team that returned seven guys from last year's team. And, they earned it. You know, these guys trusted in their coach, and it shows a lot about their character, the fact that these guys returned, and they could have gone anywhere else to play basketball. So, you know, before we got into this summer series, we spoke a lot on chemistry, and chemistry would be the thing that leads any team to be successful in the summer series to a championship. And I think this team possessed that because, again, those guys returned, and not only did they return, mm-hmm. but they trusted in Coach Small, and again, they were successful.
And Edmonton, again, you know, even when we were talking with the Saskatchewan Rattlers, who had a complete turnover in their roster, and we kept saying, defending champs, but no one really was on that roster who had won it the year before. For Edmonton, to your point, they have players who remember that semifinal loss last year by a bucket to the eventual champions, the Rattlers.
Right, and not only did they remember, but what I appreciated about this team was the fact that they let Xavier Moon be the catalyst, and everybody accepted a role. So for a team to be good, everybody has to fall into line. It's like a puzzle for everybody to fit. So Xavier Moon was the head of this snake, the head of this machine, and everybody, you know, picked up where they fit in. And then we see success here today.
Mm-hmm. We always try to find that winning formula. Whenever a team wins, we say, how? Sometimes you just can't explain it. It just works. And it did just that for the entire series and on the day that it counted for the Edmonton Stingers. Let's throw it to Amy Otterbert and the awarding of the trophy.
Welcome to the CEBL Summer Series post-game championship celebration and trophy presentation. What a wonderful 16 days of basketball celebrating the CEBL and an incredible Canadian basketball community. With me on stage, we have the founder, a true visionary of the CEBL, Mr. Richard Petko, and our commissioner and CEO, Mr. Michael Morielli. Have you breathed yet? Take a breath.
Oh, yeah. This is fantastic. The game on the court today was fantastic. Two great teams. Kudos to both of them. Only one trophy to give out. We'll give that out shortly. But if I had many more, I'd give them out to every single person in this room today. All those people have done the tireless work and hours to get us to the point where we can actually play in a pandemic situation. It's kind of remarkable. Our partners, our sponsors, the CBC, Media Pro, our coaches, officials, players, staff of all types, from the scorer's table to holding cameras to behind the scenes, and the fans at home. We can't wait to bring this trophy back. I know these guys can't wait to bring it back to Edmonton, and then to be able to bring back CBL basketball to you in 2021, hopefully in a more profound way, live and in front of some fans.
I do have to say, though, thank you for this gift of basketball during this time. I think I speak for a lot of people when I say that. And before we award the trophy, will you do this the honor of this MVP for the championship weekend?
Yeah, this shouldn't come as much surprise. The MVP of the CBL Championship game for 2020 is none other than Xavier Moon.
Congratulations, Xavier. To be in a gym during this time is special, but to win a championship, different ball game. Tell me how you feel about, with this group of guys, being able to do this during this time in our world.
Man, we work so hard. A lot of hard work on and off the court. Big compliments to Mike Morielli and everybody else who put this together for allowing us to play the game that we love. And, I mean, it's a big compliment to our team, man. We worked hard. Everybody stayed together, and we got it done.
since I've gotten to know you guys during training camp and throughout this process, the one thing nobody here has shied away from was talking about wanting to come back and win this after feeling like you fell short last year. I know you have a fantastic Edmonton fan base. If you could just give them a message about your team and what it took to do this.
Man, it was a hard journey, but it was an easy decision to come back. Like you said, we fell short last year, so we knew we had to come back, and everybody said they was coming back. So we got the job done, and, man, we love Edmonton.
Let me ask you about us northern folk, though. What do you think about basketball up here?
I love it. If I could stay year-round, I would.
Hints? All right, and now we're going to set it over to Mr. Richard Petko to award the championship trophy.
Okay. I would love to hand out this championship trophy with my own hands, guys, but I broke one, so sorry about that. Coach Smalls, your team came up really big. Congratulations on 8 straight wins to be the 2020 CBL champions. Mike Morreale, please do the pleasure and hand it over to Coach Smalls, what he deserves.
This experience with these men, what can you tell about them with the process to get to the top?
Yeah, that's the thing. We focused on the process more than the goal. And I told them, like, let's take it day by day, inch by inch, and just continue to get better. And all the credit goes to these guys. You know, the first game was tough, and we got punched in the mouth. But I told them, you're a winner, you learn. And they just refused to lose.
All right, now that we're done, no secrets being saved. What is the biggest strength of this group as a collective group?
Well, that's the biggest strength. We're a group. Any game, anyone could be the player of the game, and they just play for each other, and they're very selfless, and they sacrifice for one another, and that's the thing. Bringing back the core was the key, and we just got it done when we need to get it done.
Thanks, Coach. I had to take a foul. Jordan, come over here. Congratulations. All right, Jordan, you were clearly one of the leaders. You were all over the court this entire experience, but you're also a basketball coach, so tell me about what you'll remember most about this process.
As a basketball coach, I was pretty disappointed with my performance tonight. Can't imagine what Jermaine was feeling. Don't know why he subbed me back in the fourth quarter, but the team was great. Guys stuck together, guys executed, especially defensively down the stretch. Couldn't say more about these guys.
And President Brett Fraser, how many Frosties does he owe you after that trophy?
I'm more of like a Baconator guy. Don't like the empty calories in the Frosty, you know what I mean? So,
congratulations. Go enjoy them, all right? Thanks. You for your time. And thank you. We'll go back to you, Andy.
Well, let the party continue. The boys are having some fun. Why not? They are champions. We'll be back to wrap here inside our CBC Sports Studios. There you go. Edmonton Stingers, 2020 CBL champs.
Voltaren Emyl Gel back in muscle pain with a no-mess applicator. Simply pull, squeeze, and apply right where it hurts to relieve pain and inflammation at its source. And no more messy hands. Voltaren Emyl Gel back in muscle pain.
My name is Christine Payne. I'm an associate here at Amazon.
Step into the blue line, sir.
This device is giving us an accurate temperature check.
You're good to go?
I have to take care of my coworkers. That's how I am. I have a son, and he said, one day I'm going to be like you. I'm going to help people.
You're good to go, ma'am?
I hope so. This is my passion. If I can take care of everyone who's sick out there, I would do it in a heartbeat.
This year, my family didn't go abroad.
My parents and I were just a few hours from home.
My mom found a place on Trivago. It was the best time of my life because I met Lisa.
Because I met Ben.
Find more than what you're searching for. Trivago. Compare accommodation offers from the leading brands and find the best deal for you. Hotel, vacation rental, and much more. Trivago.
Canada Deposit Insurance Corporation is a federal agency that protects your money when you deposit it with any of our member institutions. Look for our logo, however you bank. CDIC. See how we protect your money.
If we knew how many plastic bottles were thrown away every day, we would press a button.
One SodaStream bottle can save thousands of bottles. SodaStream. Make fresh, sparkling water at home. Make a difference.
It really is a beautiful trophy. We had a chance to have it come by the CBC Sports Studios, and now I have a feeling it's not going to leave the hands of any of those Edmonton Stingers players as they are crowned champions. Annie Petrillo, Javon Shepherd. All right, we know it's been a crazy 2 weeks. 26 games culminates with the championship game here on Sunday, and already a very successful second year, of course, given a pandemic. But I mean success as far as Ottawa joined the league. Rumors of Montreal-based team joining the league next year. What does a league like this mean to basketball players?
You know what? It provides a space for these guys to get out and compete. They come home and, you know, allow them to develop their game. And I see lots of these guys are going to end up with, you know, some lucrative deals that they may not have had the opportunity before because now they're here showcasing their talents. So you definitely have to commend, as well as coaches, sorry, you don't want to forget the coaches, but you do want to commend, you know, the commissioner Mike Morielli, as well as a lot of the supporting staff and management that were able to put on such a successful event. And going forward, you know, we've seen and we've heard some whispers of some expansion teams, you know, so the sky's the limit for this league.
Yeah, and it's not just for the players, as you mentioned, it's also for the coaches to get their feet wet, officials to get their feet wet, or just at least have another place to go to as well. And you're hearing Xavier Moon. I mean, there's rumblings of, all right, he might get a lucrative European deal. There's talks of, is he NBA caliber? Would we be having these conversations if we didn't even see him here?
We wouldn't have had these conversations. And I think for a guy like that, he's able to showcase right now. There are 84 players here that are playing. Outside of the NBA, there's nobody else playing right now. So these guys are relevant. These guys are who are in front of scouts' eyes and being seen right now. So for a guy like him, you know, it's situational. So opportunities are going to come of this. And then you never know. Somebody like yourself can lace it back up.
Yeah, no, I think I would absolutely tear it up in the league, but I just don't want to show off and make anyone kind of feel bad. You're not going to let me live that down. I showed up with my grade 9 jacket and my medal because I won the Risa Championship. I'm not going to let you put me down for that one. I'm a champion, so I completely understand how Edmonton feels right now. Javon, it's been an absolute pleasure working with you. My friend, can't wait to do it again. We're not done with sports here on the network. It's been fun watching live sports. So next up on CBC, it's athletics. Tuesday, the Continental Tour Gold resumes from Finland and the Diamond League begins anew from Monaco on Friday as Noah Lyles and Safwan Hassan will test out a brand new track. You can stream those events live wherever you are as well. And next Saturday, speaking of live sport, we go from one bubble to another. Get ready for the Island Games. The CPL title chase begins this week from the University of PEI Alumni Field in Charlottetown. Join us right here starting at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. Congratulations. There we go. It's the ceremonial cutting of the net. You keep that. You are the 2020 champs, the Edmonton Stingers, on behalf of everyone here from CBC Sports. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.
This CBC original program is available in described video.
This is your marketplace. The fatty truth about coconut oil.
That's crazy, actually.
Yuck.
Ooh.
I had no clue.
And is milk good for you or bad for you?
I'm not very fond of milk.
I love milk.
Want to stop drinking this? You have to eat all this.
It's shocking.
Plus, everyone's juicing. To drink. To eat. To juice. Or not. The answer's coming right up. We're setting up shop to talk to shoppers about a big health trend. Coconut oil.
What kind of cooking oil do you use?
I do often shop for olive oil and coconut oil.
At home, I use a lot of coconut oil.
As a matter of fact, I'm from the Caribbean, so we use a lot of the coconut oil.
Yeah, so this would look familiar to you.
Very much so.
The coconut oil industry has exploded, raking in over $650 million last year alone, with big brands making healthy claims. Healthy fat. No cholesterol or trans fat.
Everywhere says that coconut oil is the best option.
Sure sounds like it's good for you.
It's good for your hair, it's good for your skin, it's good for cooking, it's good for everything.
I put a tablespoon of butter and 2 teaspoons of coconut oil in my coffee every morning, and they think that I'm nuts.
So how quickly do you go through a jar of this?
It's more a jar of this.
Wow.
I would say every couple months. I usually go through a container like this or this.
From Dr. Oz.
First of the health benefits of coconuts is weight loss. It helps you lose weight.
To vloggers.
Use coconut oil instead of olive oil.
To celebrity chefs.
And I pour it over fruits. I put it in dressings. From time to time, I've been known to put it over pasta for my daughter.
Seems like a lot of people are buying in.
Would you consider it a healthier option than some of the other oils out there?
I mean, it says organic, so it has to. Right?
It's not processed. It's like from the coconut.
It's screaming green and healthy.
I know that's high good fats, I've heard.
Along with what's called MCT.
MCT oil. That's medium chain triglycerides. They're in coconut oil.
And make sure that you're using MCT oil if you want to get these different benefits.
MCTs create energy faster.
You could use MCT oils on a salad. I could take it right off a spoon.
The wonders of MCT oil and the coconut oil craze are linked, and it all goes back to this 2003 study. Makes you wonder, is there anything to all these health claims? To find out, we tracked down the author of the study that set off the craze.
Hi, Marie Pierre.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is the shop.
All right.
Would you like a coffee?
Sure.
All right.
Marie Pierre Saint-Onge, a doctor of human nutrition from Columbia University.
2 black coffees with coconut oil, please.
Lots of people put coconut oil in their coffee, but this is a first for her.
We did research to look at the influence of MCT oil on energy expenditure and body composition.
Wait, what?
You weren't testing coconut oil.
Not at all. We were testing MCT oil. It's very purified form. MCT is a subcomponent of coconut oil, and only 15% of coconut oil is MCT.
What her research did find was a small improvement in weight loss for overweight people who consumed MCT oil, but Zippo on coconut oil.
It's often picked up as being a study that promotes coconut oil, but in fact, they're completely different.
There are brands that are promoting coconut oil as being healthy and something you can eat and cook with all the time.
Yes, it's unfortunate that coconut oil has been given this health halo.
So it's not healthy?
I would not consume it on a regular basis.
Marie Pierre is not alone. Many experts are concerned that coconut oil is high in saturated fat.
What if I told you, though, that one tablespoon of coconut oil has 13 grams of saturated fat?
Yuck.
That's more than two-thirds of your daily saturated fat limit.
That's the opposite of healthy.
Really? Oh, I didn't know that.
How does that compare with butter or olive oil?
Good question. It's the same as almost two tablespoons of butter.
All right.
Wow.
6.5 tablespoons of olive oil.
Okay.
Really?
That's crazy.
And wait for it. 2.5 tablespoons of lard.
Lard. Wow.
That stuff right here.
Damn, that's crazy, actually. I didn't realize that, yeah.
Ooh.
Okay. Here, you can have this back.
We reach out to the coconut oil companies in our story, and the ones that got back to us say new science shows the saturated fat in coconut oil doesn't have the same negative health effects as the kind in animal fats like lard and butter. They say it has health benefits, but experts we talk to say there's not enough evidence to support that. Canada's Food Guide recommends limiting intake of all saturated fat, including coconut oil.
Is the way you've been using coconut oil secretly making you fat?
Now Dr. Oz is even questioning the benefits.
Just last year, the American Heart Association came out against it.
Their conclusion? Coconut oil raises bad cholesterol and has no offsetting favorable effects.
What responsibility do you think brands and food companies have to understanding scientific studies properly?
I think it's very important for food companies to be able to translate the science that's being done in a way that's accurate and that represents what the research is actually showing.
Dietitian Andrea Miller says Canadians have jumped onto this trend without having all the information.
Some people are disappointed and frustrated because they think, well, you know, I really thought I was doing something good for my health and now I'm not. So I am concerned because I don't think people have an understanding of the implications of a diet that's really high in saturated fat. And our heart health guidelines are that we should be keeping the total saturated fat content of our diet down around 10%. So if we're putting coconut oil in our coffee or spreading it on our toast, chances are we're way overstretching that saturated fat recommendation.
She says a lot of people are caught up with the fancy claims.
It says no cholesterol or trans fat.
Coconut oil never had cholesterol and never will. Cholesterol was found only in animal products. It's almost like saying, you know, a banana doesn't have cholesterol. Well, a banana never had cholesterol and never will. Use coconut oil for flavor, not as your primary source of fat.
We tell Health Canada about the industry's claims, and we learn our government is planning to put warnings on foods high in saturated fat. Someday, if the proposal gets passed.
In the meantime, these shoppers have a message.
Do you think there should be a warning to consumers about how much saturated fat is in something like this?
100%. 100%.
Why?
Because I had no clue.
So the saturated fat is on the label, but should there be a warning?
Yeah, because I guess it feels like they're just not putting it explicitly on the label.
Until that happens.
Are you going to keep on using coconut oil?
For certain things, yes. For other things, probably take a step back and look at either canola or even lard in this case, I guess. Yeah. No, not today, not tomorrow, not ever.
Does your body need milk?
It's concerning.
It's shocking.
Serving up a dairy fact check.
I don't see the big deal of it. I feel like they should have milk anytime.
Some days it just gets kind of heated.
Can we end the food wars at this house? The truth about milk, next. Get more Marketplace. Sign up for our weekly newsletter at cbc.ca/marketplace.
So, what's everyone watching?
CBC Summer on CBC and CBC Gem.
Sounds so Canadian.
Next level.
It's a joke. This movie is going well.
Sure to sizzle.
It's got a bit of boom.
It's that good.
It's great.
It's huge.
So I'm in.
All summer long.
Wow.
Don't miss a moment. CBC Summer on CBC and CBC Gem.
I've been waiting for you.
Let me tell you about Cash Money's line of credit. It's like a credit card. It's flexible, ready cash when you need it, and whatever you need it for. You can take a bit for this, a bit for that. Pay a bit here, pay a bit there. You get the picture. Take only what you need and pay only for what you use, so you can confidently get through your cash ups and downs. Cash Money's line of credit. Simple, fast, flexible.
The summer savings event at Leon's is held over. Get special prices throughout the showroom. Plus, save up to 50% on bedroom furniture. And take 2 years to pay with 0% interest. Leon's summer savings event is held over until Wednesday. Visit leons.ca for details.
Together, we're making a difference to stop the spread of COVID-19. If you are worried you may have been exposed to the virus, get tested. Practice physical distancing and wash your hands frequently. To find out more, visit ontario.ca/coronavirus.
Forget the feeling sometimes that you don't know what's going on.
What you really came here to do, free yourself.
You speak of being free. This is your lucky day.
If that's what you got, give it to me.
Can you put a price on your dreams?
Okay, man, I'm in.
Being Black in Canada, a space for Black voices and their stories, a curated place featuring news, documentaries, arts, and more.
Tonight, the emergence of new realities, a new normal, new fears, new hopes. CBC News delivers the latest information you need to navigate these times.
Join us tonight on The National.
The Food Fact Check continues. It might not look like it.
Get out of here.
But this family is in the middle of a food war.
Not very fond of milk, just because I hear so many things about what's added in milk.
I love milk. I've been drinking it my whole life. I have it with every single meal.
Individually, Jimmy and Gina can set aside their differences.
You want to practice boxing?
But the debate really heats up when it comes to their kids, 5-year-old Eden and 2-year-old Aria.
They had a glass of milk yesterday, too.
Yeah, but that's yesterday. What about today?
We'll give them milk later, if they ask for it. They're not asking for
it
right now.
They always ask.
No, they didn't ask for it now, so we can give it to them later.
I don't see the big deal of it. I feel like they should have milk anytime. You know, if they want it, they can have it.
Some days when he's had a long day or something, then it just gets kind of heated.
That's actually a pretty nice version of our conversation.
Hey, how about you show me a pull-up?
The Kims are not alone. Seems many Canadians are avoiding milk for lots of different reasons. For Gina, it's because she's seen headlines like these.
They add like all these stuff in there, right? So that's why I'm concerned about it. Like antibiotics, growth hormones, that's not good for the kids.
And the new food guide doesn't help to clear up the debate.
Yeah, I don't. The dairy?
Would this be it?
Yeah, is this like yogurt?
But no milk.
No milk. Yeah, there's no milk on there.
It's a stark change from the previous one.
Like if you look at this one over here, right? Mm-hmm. Like this little rainbow looking thing.
Yeah.
Milk actually has its own rainbow.
Jimmy and a lot of us grew up seeing lots of milk ads. Brought to us by the multi-billion dollar dairy industry.
Yay!
So who's right? To drink milk or not to drink milk? That's the ultimate question.
And this is the first time I've seen you eat the yellow part.
To get the answer, we need to break into the Kims' food diaries.
Did you fill in that food diary this morning?
Not yet.
Not yet?
We're asking them to track everything they eat for 3 days.
I didn't snack at night. Did you snack at night?
Did I have like a granola bar?
Granola bar?
Or chocolate bar?
Chocolate bar. That sounds about right.
For anyone thinking about avoiding milk, you gotta ask yourself, can you meet all your nutritional needs without it? And can the Kims?
This is gonna be fun.
Yeah, it's gonna be great.
And they've been doing these food diaries.
To find out, we're bringing in dietitian Andrea Miller. She's reviewed their food diaries, and she's going to end this family's food war.
Hi.
Welcome,
everybody's
welcome,
here.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Based on their food diaries, this is what they eat in a day.
There's the milk. So a glass a day, that sounds about right
for
you?
Yeah, for sure. For sure, at least a glass a day.
And Gina, no milk on your plate.
No milk.
But both their kids drink milk daily.
They ask for it, so I can't always say no. I try to direct them to something else.
Taking a look.